Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
So is that coming from your laptop now? Like, are you still playing the sound through there? So that's why. Yeah.
Hello, are we live? Is that where we're at right now? Yes, we are. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Absolute Vodka Presents Live at the Landis Podcast, our weekly podcast here at the Landis Theater. Experience differently, baby. I'm still trying to get my breath back, still working on the old heart here. And again, our second tier sponsor, who we love from Uncle Steve, which is the Michael Kelly Guitar Company, michaelkellyguitars.com. As you see these wonderful guitars behind us. I changed the blue one out too, and I put this sucker up here because I like it.
Hell yeah, dude.
Because it looks really fucking cool. And somebody's back to join us again today to say hello.
He's hey been guys, away how for are a you? Bit.
Good to see you, brother.
Great to
see
to you be with back.
That very, very bright shirt on.
It's hey, man. Springtime.
Almost springtime somewhere, right?
That's it.
It is 5 o'clock somewhere, according to your shirt.
Well, that's what I was thinking. I figured I'd just go to springtime.
Holy hell, man. That thing is sweet. Not gonna lie, I have a buddy that does a Hawaiian shirt Friday. Every Friday, he wears Hawaiian shirts.
I own literally about 70 Hawaiian shirts.
If I had a buddy who wore every day Hawaiian shirt one certain day a week, I'd kick him right in his fucking balls because that's what you get for wearing
shout
a Hawaiian
out Steve.
Shirt. Yeah. But as you can see, Steve, we had a wonderful week this week, is wearing a special hoodie that was given to us by the amazing Styx band.
The backwards not, camera, really. Not it's
a,
killing
not a tribute to Styx, but an actual Styx. They were here.
The real life Styx.
In the Landis preparing for their summer tour. Actually, they went right to Connecticut and New York, and they played a couple gigs the following day. All the artists, you know, they flew in. They met locally. They all met here. Mm-hmm. They brought all the gear out. They tested everything. They did a run through of the full show. We got to see and watch basically that's a awesome. Private Styx concert.
Yes.
And then all their multi-million dollars worth of tour buses showed up and they all got on them and left.
The whole city must have been wondering what the hell is going on there.
Let me ask you guys as a fan. Like, how did they go about finding you guys? Like, how does that happen?
That's
how's
something
that connect?
We keep to ourselves. So, yeah. so. But yes, they know us. They're
that's
they're,
awesome.
They're friends of the family here, and they are family here now. We had a really great time with them. Is my thing working? Because I don't hear shit now.
I hear you yes. on mine.
Do you? Okay. Because somehow my mine just went away. Oh. I don't know what happened here. So, I don't
that's
know which
me.
One
you're this one. The one closest to you.
Oh, there we go. Hey, the one you closest guys? To me. Yeah, I'm okay. Yeah, I can hear myself a little now. Anyway, so they were here, Tommy and JY and the whole crew. Todd, who's probably to me. Since the loss of Neil Peart, probably the greatest drummer alive today.
Yeah.
The man is absolutely unbelievable, and his set was quite amazing. There's Bruce. Hey, what's going on, buddy? Also, they sent this. Let me grab this guy over here. I got this in the mail yesterday. I got this nice box addressed to me, and I got this wonderful. These guys sent this is a little thing with all the guys who signed it, but they sent this little guitar here, which I thought was really cool. We're going to put this in our green room with some cool Tommy Shaw signed my old Tommy Shaw album, so it's really cool.
Yes,
that's awesome.
But this
well,
is cool.
I haven't washed my hands yep. since you shook it. So
there you go.
Jeez,
she got gangrene.
I was going to say he's got to be signing these in that same spot every
yeah,
time.
Yeah,
yeah. Look at how his signature
works.
Goes to the
works.
Curve.
Right
he knows how to do
yep.
it. Yeah.
He's got it down.
And what a great guy, man. And all I can tell you, man, is if you're a fan of Styx and you haven't seen Styx in a long time, you really need to go. Dude, they sounded fucking stellar, man.
Incredible.
Stellar, man. Incredible. Opened up with Grand Illusion. They went on and on to do the full set for us. And, man, they sounded phenomenal. I thought that whole guitar kind of get together they had during Come Sail Away was
yes.
pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, it's worth the show. They're right now they're doing some dates on their own, and then they go on tour with Foreigner with John Waite opening up.
Oh, yes. That's a great pack.
Yeah, so it'll right? be a really, it'll exactly. be a really good show. So you know, go out there, get your tickets for Styx on tour this summer with Foreigner. Again, thank you guys, especially to JY and Tommy and Todd and the whole crew for being here. I mean, what an amazing group of people. And George, their tour manager, you know, George, we love you. I just spoke with him on the phone today. He had to call and make sure, you know, hey, man, make sure you got that guitar I sent and stuff like that. What a great idea. Awesome. Sticksworld.com is their official site.
Yes.
Get on there, get some tickets. And when you're not going to a Sticks show, you want to come to the Landis Theater.
Absolutely.
Because this weekend, we had some good shows, man.
Do you want me to show those? Like, I have three Sticks photos.
Show everybody at home. This is a little sneak preview of some of the stuff that, sneak post view of what happened here. There it is. That is, first of all, that is Tommy Shaw's guitarist.
Wow.
Tommy plays a different guitar, sometimes two different guitars per song. He never uses the same guitar. In there is also his banjo, Banjolina. And then on top is, you can't see it here, but the mandolin, of course, for Boat on the River is sitting up there. And what do you call that? Mando.
Yeah.
It was Mando, like Lando Calrissian. It was Mando. But yeah, he has names for all his guitars and stuff. But man, what a beautiful just set of instruments. These guys just packed it, and it was so nice. You got anything else from them? Look at that light. There you go. There's the, and so there's the keyboards, which I love, is because it's on a rotating thing that he actually operates. What's his? I can't think of his name right now.
Lawrence.
Used to somebody, and I won't say his name. But the singer that they have, Lawrence, is amazing, man. First of all, the guy can sing. He puts on a show. He's got moves. He's got charisma. He knows how to how to front a band, basically. You know,
he's a funny guy too.
Absolutely. And there's Todd's drum set, which again was just ridiculous. That's them. They were just setting up, so all the drums aren't there, of course. But and there's their basically their monitor rigs and all that stuff on the side. It was a really fun time, man. It was a fun time. Some great guys, and you know, we welcomed them back before their next tour.
That was my first time actually getting to see them. Every time they come around to town, I always have something either going on here.
What first show was a private show?
Yeah, right.
What better way could you?
What a better way to experience it for the first time?
Steve got my desk. Steve got to meet Sticks.
Yeah,
a private show, and he got to meet Isaiah Pacheco this week.
Yeah. Oh yeah,
Isaiah is back in town, and he stopped by Casey Ray's. We were hanging out on, what's that, Friday night or Saturday? Friday night.
It's Friday night. Yeah.
And of course, on 4/20, we will be having the Isaiah Pacheco second Super Bowl ring party at Casey Ray's.
On 4/20.
Yeah, there he is. Congratulations, Isaiah. Man, we love him, man. He's a good friend of ours now, and he's just a great guy. And I wanted Steve was on vacation last time he was here, so we didn't get to meet him when he won the Super Bowl last time.
I was watching intently on a plane. Yeah, that's crazy. I was flying to LA.
So Isaiah's back. We love him, and he's a dear friend of ours too. So and he'll be back.
What a great guy too. I mean, absolutely you never know, a great guy.
Stop into Casey Ray's. You might meet Isaiah. He happens to kind of like it here, and it is his home away from home, and his father as well. You know, we love him. Bunch of great guys. We really love having them. But two good shows, man.
Two great shows. Two fantastic
Starman was back, and as always, man, if you watched last week's podcast and you got to see the guys, man, what a show they put on, man. Yeah. And they did Ziggy Stardust, the whole album, and dude, it's like
knocked it out of the park.
We turned it into basically like space in here for the whole show, and it was just so cool, man. Not for the whole show, for the whole album. And then when they went on to the next album, we kind of spiced it up.
You really opened it up, I'll tell you what. You really did.
I went from space to what the hell's going on here? Let's dance. Well, you went to the 80s. Yeah. You know, you went from the 70s to the 80s. Yeah. You know, and it was it. Again, I love these guys.
I love them, man, because they put on such a show, and the music is one of those bands, you know, it's something that lets us go a little wild.
Yeah.
You know, we can really take off and run with the shit when it's a band like that. And
that's awesome.
You know, either the lyrics have a lot of meaning, it's really cool music, whatever it may be. But we really get to take off and run with it.
I get to do Bowie stuff. You know, I was always a fan of Bowie growing up. I saw him several times. And to be able to sit here now and do shows and be able to take an amazing band and be able to surround them with stuff. Your lights going, the sound, Bob had killer again.
Killed it. Killed it as always. I tried to call him earlier. He didn't answer.
Yeah, but again,
I know Tommy that I didn't call him today.
So. As great as they are, we just followed it up with a band that played here almost 2 years ago, 3 years ago maybe now.
Yeah.
Who's next?
Bro. They're one of our first bands.
I'm telling you, man. Yeah. I'm going to have them back, and people need to come out and see this band. People left here with their jaws dropping. One lady's like, oh my God, I feel like I'm back in my youth again. These guys deliver.
They do.
I don't know if you listen to The Who,
they do.
But The Who's music fucking rocks, man.
It does. It does.
And most of their songs are about like 13 seconds long. Mm-hmm. So they have like 700 songs they play.
Yeah.
But man, they kick ass, man.
There you go. One for you. It's already gone.
They literally kick ass. But I know. There we go. It's a fucking squirrel.
Thanks, Jeff.
You throw squirrels up all fucking show long.
I just have to throw it in there.
In the middle of something, throw a fucking squirrel up again. Anyway, I was saying, but the Who's Next is a wonderful band, man. Great guys. They also brought us bagels.
Yes. And I'll tell you, these ones were they're up there too, man.
I tell you, I had four of them.
Bill was so funny.
I did.
I completely forgot that. Well, I was keeping a certain somebody out of your hair, so he was back once again. So I didn't get to grab my other bagels, but that one that I had, man, I'll tell you what, that one was up there.
Dude, they were good. They were good. Bronx they were one. Really
you
good.
You had, I'm not gonna lie, the way it was toasted looked really good.
It was perfect.
Yeah, Bruce, I know you're watching, and all your bands from Long Island, and we cannot thank you enough for bringing bagels, and we encourage you to continue bringing bagels.
It is a welcome addition.
We went out.
That comment was already there.
Yeah, we went out and bought a toaster oven just to make damn sure we could keep. Who's that? Oh, they are the best, Bruce. They're phenomenal. We're going to show some clips too, but I will tell you, we bought a toaster oven just for the Long Island bagels, the Queens bagels too. Don't get me wrong. The bagel sandwich things. They're wonderful too. They're delicious, but like I said, they make a good sandwich.
Yeah. They would make a good sandwich.
So I got to ask with the Who's Next, unfortunately I missed the show, but Stage Destruction, do they get into
now,
any of that stuff?
I don't think they can afford that.
Yeah. Probably.
But dude, they have a beautiful drum set. The guys are just stellar, man. And they're just such good guys. They left here going, dude, one of the best shows we've done in a long time. We're so glad to be back.
Hell yeah.
Do you have any shots of that? Any video of those, Case?
Starman or Who's Next?
Let's do Who's Next first.
Okay.
Since we're talking about it, man, what a show, man. And if you missed it, I'm telling you, you really missed a good show, man. A really good show. What do you got?
In a box,
yeah, yeah,
living in a box, it's a put on. That's all you have, all that. That's all we have. Oh man,
yes, I have some shots.
Oh my god, that was such a good show.
Can I have your paper?
Sure,
we have a correction.
Oh, dude,
sure,
look at that shot. Hand.
Yeah, see, I love that gobo secretly, I don't get to use it enough.
Even the costumes are great. That drum set is killer, man. I love his drum set, man. And that logo looks so good.
And is
there
that the Keith Moon thing plastered all over it?
Oh, it's absolutely.
Great.
It's so
great.
Fucking cool.
I told him when they were on the podcast, I was like, oh, man, I can't wait till you kick that shit over in the middle of the show. And he's
he
like, oh,
kicking,
no.
He ain't like,
can't do that.
You ain't kicking nothing.
Not that drum set. That
let me see yours here. Yep. Just want to make sure you got the right thing here.
Uh-oh.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
Yep. Just a pronunciation update.
Oh, no. Something happened.
Okay.
There you go. Yep.
Oh, perfect. Penis with a P. Oh.
You thought it was penis, right?
I was going to say penis. Yeah, later.
That's somehow like an internet trend.
How about Bowie? You got any of that Bowie stuff? You probably got like 400 Bowie clips because you love Bowie. You get one Who clip. Dude, those guys are great too. I got more on my thing here. Yes, no, maybe?
Yes, I don't want to blow your ears out. I'm trying to turn that
off.
Yeah. on, man. Tell me that fucking video wasn't sweet on that one, man.
Just love it. It was such a good show.
It's all AI created video.
Mm-hmm.
And it fits so well for that song. And man, you just kind of got to let it ride. And I run like three different AIs and mix them together so you can kind of go from one to the other.
I love that you're embracing the AI thing.
Dude, it's so cool, man.
Most other content people are like, fuck AI, blah, blah, blah. He's like, dude, you mix them together. It's fucking sweet.
What?
I was just saying to Jimmy Graham in the other room, I'm like, normally I hate AI. I'm like, but I needed a comedy rooster doing stand up.
Look, I understand the guy didn't like to practice. But he was probably one of the better players the Sixers ever had.
Woo!
Practice. Brain.
Talking about practice.
Practice. Now, look, artificial intelligence has its place with certain things.
Yeah.
And I think it adds to what we do here, because when you have a busy week and you have a lot of time, you can feed it some music, you can feed it some ideas, and it gives you some cool content to play around with that's not the same shit you're seeing anywhere else.
Right.
And the thing is, you're not going to see that anywhere else. You're going to see it here at the Landis. You're going to see it on our walls. You're going to see it surrounded. And when you leave here, that's it. Yeah. If you can go see Starman 1,000 other places, you will never see what you saw here.
We couldn't even make it again if we tried.
Well, I have it now, so.
Well, but even that, I mean, you know, you mix it.
Oh yeah. Once I mix it, you'll never mix it the same again.
You'll never get it.
Yeah, which is so cool. But that's one of the
favorite thing about here.
One of the things I love about here, when you take Steve with the lights, you take my video, and then you take this amazing sound that we have, and you put all that together, you get one hell of a show that you can't get anywhere else. So if you're a fan of music and you're going to other places to see these bands, man, take your time, travel a little bit, come here and get a full experience. Even the bands, I will tell you, I'll go back to Styx. Tommy Shaw sat right there and said, wow, this place sounds amazing. Absolutely amazing. He couldn't believe it. This is Tommy Shaw.
Yeah.
From Styx. And Tommy still sounds like he's 20.
Yeah.
I got to say, there's some venues out there that I've been to. Some of these venues are nearby that have started picking up better known names. But the problem being, and I've noticed because I was there enough times to know, there's no backdrop. There's no production. There's not, you have the band and that's it. And it really does add the next level. When you have all that, when you have the production,
it makes
the sound and the lights. And I mean,
that's why, I mean, we've had one band come in and hang a banner behind them. And
that was,
don't even do that anymore.
Yeah, that was
I mean, even them, you know, they were one that was like,
and they're like, you know what?
We do the banner thing.
I got to admit though, that tour, their banner lit up. From behind.
It was cool.
And it was cool because the way the bird, it had like this crow and stuff, and it kind of worked.
It wasn't just a regular banner.
Gotcha.
But, when they saw what we do, they're like, yeah, let's fuck it. Why sit here and spend all this time unraveling a banner, hanging it up, putting all the lights behind it when it's 10 times better.
Speaking of which, I noticed they're on the books. You guys
June
have scheduled.
7th, Case, 8th. When are they coming back?
The Daisies?
Yeah.
June 8th.
June 8th.
The Daisies are back, man. On the 7th.
Yes. Oh, what a weekend.
Afro Man.
What a weekend.
Wait.
June's a great month, CT.
Might as well just park in the parking lot.
Who do we have?
Sleep in my car.
We have somebody else that Sunday, too. Who's that Sunday? Don't we have a band that Sunday, too?
The 9th?
Yeah. We just signed somebody the 9th.
Oh.
I forget. I am going to look.
Good question. No.
Does anybody know what's the waiting music on?
No, I know who it is, but we haven't signed a contract yet. That's why.
So we
will have something on the night.
Something
that I think a lot of people are going to love, especially if you're a mother or father with kids that are on crack and love a certain artist that we all think is fucking crackhead. But
I know who
everyone
it is
loves
now, too.
Her.
We haven't signed that yet, but
we will let you know next week.
You know,
once it's signed. But yes, so Dead Daisies are coming back. But this weekend, and they're already on, we have, this is probably our third Meatloaf band that we brought in.
Yeah.
The first one came in from California. They were really great guys, great people. They came in, they rehearsed here. They did a show. It was a really wonderful time.
Mm-hmm.
Another Meatloaf band came in. They were great. This Meatloaf band, I watched the video, and I think they're really great. So we said, look, let's go with this one.
Awesome.
Now, I don't think their Meatloaf was available, right? We got a couple people from the...
Yes, I think he's at work, but we have their...
Jeez, got a
there's
fucking
a song
job.
About that, isn't there? Isn't there a fucking song about
what,
a meatloaf
couldn't make the podcast?
No, about working and you couldn't do this. Yeah. Shit. Fuck. I can't think of
it. I will say, Meatloaf was the one artist for me that I wasn't a big fan of before I saw him live. And then he completely won me over when I seen him live.
Yeah.
My wife was a big fan, so I took my wife and he floored me.
Just the combo of you know, Meatloaf and Jim Steinman, man. That's
a
killer.
Well, Steinman's
a killer. Yeah.
Their sax player says he actually has a gig tonight. So he is out.
So he's out gigging. Okay. Well, I'll take that, man. I'm like, he's probably like, it was he like, yeah, you want fries with that? And I'm like, come on, man. We're trying to sell tickets here to your amazing show.
He's an accountant.
Yeah. Well, no, he's an accountant. It's tax,
well, it's tax season.
It is tax season. But you want to bring those peeps on? There it is. All revved up. The ultimate Meatloaf tribute. And I will tell you, by watching some of the video, I think they might be the ultimate tribute. Find out.
I'm excited. I love.
It is this Friday. It is March 29th, 8 p.m. Doors open at 7. Dude, that's a really cool shot there, too, man. That looks cool. I worked with Meatloaf.
Me back to the days.
They're a really awesome Meatloaf couple. Like him and Nico, they look really awesome together.
Well, I cannot wait. Is she on?
Yes.
Oh, so at least we get the better half.
Hey.
Oh, no. Wrong, guys. We got, who wants Meatloaf? We got you, two beautiful lady. Well, you got the fire going. Where are you? The North Pole?
I'm in Wading River.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's gorgeous. But I love
that horse country, she is. I'm in Queens.
Oh, you're in Queens. Hey, you're my girl. New York, all the way, girlfriend. Hey, man, it's so awesome to have you on. We were just saying, we've had a couple Meatloaf tributes here. I actually worked with Meatloaf a few times.
Wow.
A great guy, great guy. He's done, we were talking about earlier today, you know, he's done one of my, I love the movie. I don't know if you ever saw the movie Roadie.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Oh, dude, I got two copies of the soundtrack in my office. You ever see Roadie? Come on, you guys are in a Meatloaf tribute. What?
No.
Oh, man.
All right, after this show,
okay, put it on the
sitting in the green room, and we are watching Roadie. It was Meatloaf's actual first film. He was the lead in the movie. He played a roadie. Deborah Harry's in it.
Wow.
A bunch of other bands are in it. He basically plays a roadie who helps out bands. And then what happens is at one point, Deborah Harry's doing a show out in the middle of nowhere, and they lose electric. So he actually goes around picking up cow turds, puts them in a thing, creates electricity out of it, and the show goes on thanks to Meatloaf.
Wow. And cow turds.
He was also in a movie with Michael Keaton called The Big Squeeze.
I know that one.
Where he played a villain, like, and he didn't really speak the whole movie. He just kind of went, made this face the whole time. Yeah, Meat's been in a couple great things. But Roadie's just, it's a fun movie, man. And if you love Meatloaf, you need to watch it. I tell anybody.
Check it out. I never even
have
to.
That. Oh, it's such a great, and the soundtrack's phenomenal. Yeah. It's got, like, Alice Cooper on the soundtrack.
Really?
I think Alice Cooper's in the movie, too. Wow. There's all kinds of appearances of all kinds.
I definitely got
Alice
to see
is
this
definitely
movie
in
now.
The movie. I remember it now. But there's a whole bunch of great bands in the movie. But we had three. You're our third Meatloaf tribute, and I will tell you, we watched your video, and instead of asking the other one to come in, we decided that we're going to give you the shot because we thought it was a pretty badass video, and we really like you guys, and we're big Meatloaf people, so we're trying to find the ultimate Meatloaf tribute. And wow, this could be like
thank
a
you
contest.
So much. You definitely found it.
We could do a TV show with you guys trying to find the ultimate Meatloaf tribute band here at Landis.
Well,
so you guys are. So now you guys, are you musicians in the band? You singers in the band?
We both sing, and I'm a sax player as well.
Oh,
given
the sax,
my name. I'm Sax Kitten.
Sax Kitten. Yeah. You got to have shirts that say Sax Kitten on them, right?
I don't, but I have ears and a tail, so.
Well, that's even better.
the shirts
we have right here.
Oh, I like that shirt. That is a nice shirt.
That's
are you guys
awesome.
Going to have merch available here for people?
I think so.
Yeah.
Good. I would always bring merch because one of the things we also have is usually a good walk-up as long as they don't say it's going to flood again and scare the hell out of everybody on the planet. Because
yeah.
CT over here is afraid of water. So and so
I
are a lot
melt,
of people,
man.
You know. But yeah, last week we usually have a good turnout, and it slowed sales down a little because all they did was warn us about flooding, and then of course 4 hours before the show started, the rain stopped and there was no flooding, and on the highways, so people could have come, but and it sucks. But we still had a decent turnout, a couple really great bands. So tell me, Meatloaf, why Meatloaf? So Are you married and or engaged or somehow with the gentleman who does Meatloaf?
Well, it's funny because we're actually married to other bandmates besides Meatloaf.
Oh, right. Wow.
Everyone in the audience, when we do the meet and greet, they always think that me and John are a couple.
Okay.
We've done a really good show. We have good choreography.
Well, then that means you're doing a good job.
You're selling that.
Yeah, you're selling it. That's
we sell it.
Yeah, that's awesome. Ham it up too. There's a lot of comedy in our act, so you'll kind of see us going back and forth.
Well, when you're doing a band with a guy whose name is Meatloaf, the comedy is just part of it from day one. You know what I'm saying? And I will tell you, knowing him, he's quite the comedian.
I will say, when I saw him live, one of the things that surprised me about him.
That man is a trip. Say
John
the least.
Really has that personality. He's just naturally like that in his life.
That's awesome.
He's a jokester. He's just hysterical. So he's always coming up with crazy things to do.
Sounds like him. Everyone's going to think he never passed away.
Well, that's what I said. When I watched the video, that's what I thought. I'm like, wow, this is like Meatloaf. Like the other ones. The one guy kind of looked like Meatloaf, you know, he had the look really down, like really down.
Yeah.
The other one sounded a little more like Meatloaf, but this one I thought really made me feel like I was watching Meatloaf.
Embodied the whole
thing. Yeah. The videos I saw kind of felt like you guys embodied it. And as a group, it was a lot of fun to watch. So I am so blown away excited. We got billboards going up for the weekend on the digital billboard. So we really want to get people out to see this because.
Yeah, for sure. We're so
excited.
Huge Meatloaf
fan. Oh, he did Rocky Horror too. Remember he?
Oh yeah.
Which?
Oh yeah.
Which I'm working on a little Rocky Horror thing too with some of the original cast members. For this year, kind of working on something there too, which would kind of be cool. Unfortunately,
my wife and I are huge Rocky Horror.
Yeah, that'd be a lot of fun. That'd be a lot of fun. And we have a.
She is too.
Are you?
Oh yeah.
Gotta love it, man.
That's how I got into Meatloaf in the first place.
Well, because they ate him or?
I just love the music of Rocky Horror. I'm so into it.
Oh, it's phenomenal. It really is. And, you know, Barry's still out there doing his thing and the two girls are out there. So I'm kind of in discussion with them on seeing how we can bring the show here. Them doing basically a Rocky Horror show of sorts.
That would be awesome.
Yeah, especially with Barry, because Barry's really like living it again. And he's really realizing, you know, that. That's the only thing he's ever done worth a shit. So I should probably go back to it. Mm-hmm. No, it's the truth. It's life sucks, but Barry's great. And that was such an iconic role. And for Meatloaf, probably one of his most iconic. If you say Meatloaf was in a movie, most people will say, oh, yeah, Rocky Horror.
Yeah.
They don't know Rhodey.
The song Hot Patootie. So.
Which you have to. You have to.
Pretty sure that's on our set list for Friday.
Oh, yes, it is.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it is. That's probably one of the songs that most people know, believe it or not, of his, because, you know, a lot of people know Dashboard and all those songs, but that's just one that's like around the world. Everyone knows Hot Patootie, Bless My Soul. They know the movie. They know. And he was so good in that, man.
Oh, yeah.
He was.
He was such a character in it. And it's just, God, he's so missed, you know.
But you couldn't beat him in Fight Club either. That's my movie.
Oh, I forgot he was in Fight Club with his titties.
Bob, man.
Yeah, Bob had some big old titties.
His name is
titties.
Robert Paulson.
Bob.
His name is Robert
I almost forgot
Paulson.
About Fight Club.
Yeah,
that's right,
my
man.
Movie, man.
Oh, man, he's such a good dude. Yeah, like I said, Meat was a good dude, man.
Yeah.
I was lucky enough to be around him. I was there when he got in a couple fights with people more than once. As he didn't.
A few times.
He liked things his
way. During what period of time were you there with him?
That would have been, I really don't want to promote the show right now that I was working on, but it was a television show that he was on, and it was pretty badass. I don't remember what year it was. I'm going to say maybe 2009, 2008, maybe.
Okay.
I forget. I have a friend
who used to play in the band, but it was back in the late 80s, early 90s.
86, 87.
Oh, no. Yeah, I played back in, I worked on, I guess I could say it, right? Nobody cares. I worked on a show called The Apprentice.
Oh,
and
when he was on there.
Oh, yeah. Right. Him and Gary Busey. Were going out. It was absolutely one of the greatest times.
Entertainment goldmine.
I was in the film and TV business for a very long time, and then I decided, you know, I would buy this venue and give amazing bands and musicians like you guys a place to really perform and put on one hell of a show. Because we're a little different. We were talking about that earlier. When you guys get here, I think you'll see that. We call people actually call us the mini sphere. We are surrounded by video here. We have walls that light up. We have screens that light up. We have screens above you, screens behind you. We have some of the best VL lighting that money can buy. And we have one of the best sound guys and some of the best sound equipment. It really is. We put everything, all that money I made in TV and film is in this building now.
Wow. Awesome.
So, and it really, it makes for a really great place for you guys to perform. And you'll see when you're on the stage, we've had some of the biggest national artists stand on stage and stare at everything going on and go, what the hell just happened, man? Mm-hmm. We had who do we have here? Octane.
Octane.
And we had Brian, and what's the band? He's with Candlebox. We had Brian, who's a guitar player for Candlebox, and his original band Octane here, and they sold out. And afterwards, Brian said, man, he goes, I've been in this business for years, touring with Candlebox all over the world. He goes, this is the best production I've ever been a part of. And we kind of blew him away. And of course, Candlebox is kind of closing doors, so we're mm-hmm. talking about maybe, I would love Brian to get them here. We'd love that too. But tell me, so Meatloaf, what got you guys into the band? I mean, what started it?
Well, I know the story of how it started, basically. So John, who's Meatloaf, and his best friend Jimmy, who's our bass player, about 10 years ago, were thinking, like, what kind of tribute band could we do? And they had all these different ideas, different things they were trying out. And Jimmy was like, well, John, why don't you do Meatloaf? Because then you don't have to stop eating donuts.
I'm okay with that.
That is smart. So,
that was basically how it started. No, and then Colleen, I came into the band six years ago.
Didn't he perform at Meatloaf back in the day as well?
I don't know that story.
I don't know. I think he did. I think, you know.
Well, Meatloaf's band still performs. Bat,
right?
What they call Bat. They call Bat.
Yeah, they're out there.
They were called Bat, but they just renamed themselves, I think.
Did they? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. I know they played locally a few times, but yeah, I think they even talked to us at one time. But it's just
yes.
No offense. Without Meatloaf, you know, you're a band. You know, yeah. I mean, it's not.
And they're
it wasn't
a great
called,
band. Like, yeah,
they are great.
They're great, but Caleb doesn't really look like Meatloaf. I don't think he really sounds like him.
I don't think he sounds like him at all. And I think that's the biggest issue. Yeah. If you're going to do an experience, and again, that's what I said. When I watched your videos, man, you guys blew me away. And I'm like, this band in this setting, in this venue, is going to blow people's socks off. And now that you're telling me you kind of do that whole Meatloaf comedic thing. Because again, he was that kind of guy.
Yeah, he was.
Oh yeah, he was. It's highly entertaining.
Good.
Never a dull moment in the show.
We do costume changes and the choreography. Right.
See, that's what was missing for me during the Bat show, because I have seen them and they were like they're like you said, they're good, but you lose a lot of what makes Meatloaf Meatloaf.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, we have musicians here that are phenomenal. Like the guys who booked you from GNR, these guys, they brought in a band called Hourglass last week, James Taylor, the week before, actually. And I've seen James Taylor several times, love James Taylor. I have never seen a band on the stage that literally sounded and played exactly like James Taylor before.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
The entire band, all the nuances that he does live that you don't hear on the albums, they did it all.
Yep.
That's what GNR these guys bring. I mean, Bruce and these guys really bring some great acts, you know, and Guy, Bruce and these guys, Bruce and Guy. and that's why I'm excited to see you guys, because I truly believe that you guys are going to blow our socks off with Meatloaf, which is I've been waiting for that, to be honest with you. I've really been waiting for that Meatloaf band. So, give me. So 10 years they've been together. How long you been with the band?
I've been in 6 years, and then I brought my husband Nick into the band, who's our drummer.
Oh, so, excellent!
Nice.
Yes, and then
I've been in for three, but it feels like eight.
You've been in for three, you said?
3 years, but it feels longer. And my husband plays guitar as well.
Oh, in the band.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, see, we'll go back to Bat. Again, what I was getting at with the other band was you have amazing musicians that can play the music all day long. You need the guy up front that makes you believe you're watching James Taylor. You need the guy up front that makes you believe you're experiencing Meatloaf. And I think that's a key. And I've heard you sing with him, and I think it's phenomenal. So I am so excited for this show. Thank you. I need a T-shirt, man. I like the t-shirt.
Oh, we got shirts. We're bringing them.
I love the t-shirt
and
already.
And bandanas.
Oh, nice.
Bananas.
Branded bananas.
Meatloaf never ate a banana.
That's the joke.
He ate a bunch.
Yeah, but wait, who's that talking? Is that your husband, the drummer?
Yeah, you want to say hi?
Again, why is he not
This is our
on?
Drummer, Nick.
Why are you not on?
Where are you?
How you doing, brother?
I'm doing pretty well, man. Looking forward to seeing you guys Friday.
Dude, we're excited, man. We're excited because, like I said, you're going to see when you get here. It's a different kind of venue we built here. It's not
Let me tell you, we're a different kind of band, so we're going to match really good.
I hope so, because like I said, we've been looking for the right Meatloaf, you know, experience here, and I think this might be the one. Again, we've had a couple, but we haven't found. And when we find the right band, we bring them back over and over again, and we really start pushing hard to get these seats filled.
I promise you, you're going to have a lot of fun. Really, yeah. Awesome. The music's really good, but Mikola and John and Colleen, they do a hell of a job up front, man. It's really fun. You're going to have a ball. Trust me.
Oh, we can't wait. We can't wait.
See you guys.
We're excited.
Now wait, does he wear a cat suit as well or no? We just can't see it.
No, but he does have a couple of costumes.
Oh, nice.
We'll leave that as a surprise.
Oh no.
Chuck, can I ask you guys like how you put out your playlist? Like, do you go by like Meat Loaf certain tours, or do you guys kind of pick the songs that you love? How do you go about putting the playlist together for shows?
Well, John is the one that really is the mastermind behind it. And we definitely make sure to always do all the hits because we want to do what people want to hear. But we'd also throw in some like little, you know, songs that people don't necessarily know. Like there's one from the 60s it was a duet with someone named Stoney that it was called What You See Is What You Get. Most people aren't really familiar with it, but it's a really cool jam tune. And it's a tune where we can like feature the band more. We do, you know, a lot of band instrumental solos while Meat's doing costume changes. So we have to get creative and featuring the band in different ways. So we just try to, you know, feature everybody in a different creative style.
Awesome.
That's awesome.
That's actually smart. And it's a good way because we get a lot of bands here that they'll just vamp.
Yeah.
Well, there's a costume change, and you're like, yo, man, come on now. And it's like, I mean, is this guy zipper stuck or what back there? Because it's been going on for 30
minutes. Yeah, everyone in the band gets a feature to some degree. So
that's awesome.
How about this? What is your first? Well, let's start at the top, and let's say, what was your first experience like hearing Meat Loaf? Like, do you remember your first like Meat Loaf song you heard, album? What's your favorite? What got you personally? Bad Out of Hell?
Bad Out of Hell for me. For sure.
Well, for you, I know it's Rocky Horror, right?
For me, it's Rocky Horror. Yeah. That's how I got into it. I really, you know, I grew up in the 80s and 90s, and I wasn't really like Meat Loaf wasn't really on my radar when I was high school and college. And then after I got out of college, I got an opportunity to play for a Rocky Horror production. And that's kind of when I discovered all of it. And then it blew me away. I was like, oh, my God, this music is amazing. And then I found all about Jim Steinman. And
Steinman's just amazing. But yeah. I think honestly, a lot of people were turned on to Meat Loaf via Rocky Horror because it was such a cult classic. It was such a big thing. I mean, when I was a kid in high school, I grew up in the 80s as well. That was like my high school years. I mean, we used to go to the midnight showings at the Harwin Theater and – you know what I mean? They used to do the every Saturday night you go there and they would throw shit at you and you know you would have fun watching the people act in front of the screen. It was a lot of fun. And then years later, I found myself dressed in a pair of gold underpants, running around the theater acting like Rocky.
Yeah, baby.
So I did that as well. But it was that. But yeah, for me, it was. I'll go back to Bad Out of Hell as well. Bad Out of Hell was one of those albums that I remember distinctly. And I got to see, of course, I got to not only, you know, work with him, meet the man, but, you know, years before I got to see him live in concerts. But it really when he was still Meat Loaf, you know what I mean? Before he's, you know, the dementia and a lot of the stuff that you know, started to settle in. Because when I got to work with him, he wasn't all there, but he was still fun. He was still funny. He was still a good guy, but a lot of his memory was gone. I even mentioned Roadie as being like this great movie, and he looked at me like I was fucking crazy. And then all of a sudden he went, Roadie! And just stared at me. I'm like, yeah, he goes, you saw it? I'm like, yeah, he goes, oh, what a great time that was. And then he got it, but it took him like 10 minutes and he turned around, just stared at me and went, Roadie! It's like he almost forgot he made the movie. You know, it was fantastic. Yeah. What about you guys? How about Meat Loaf? What got you?
It was my grandfather, honestly. My grandfather was more Fleetwood Mac. My grandmother loved Meat Loaf. Absolutely love Meat Loaf. So we'd be driving around in the car, and Meat Loaf was always on. Hmm. Always on, yes. And I remember singing along, not knowing what the lyrics meant. as like a little kid.
Well,
I'm sure it was funny as shit for everybody else. But.
Yes.
I'll tell you, when I first got together with my wife, she was a giant Meatloaf fan. So I decided to take, we went to, it's not even there anymore, the Tower Theater.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we went to the Tower and saw him. And like they Philly. Were saying, yeah, yep. The comedy was there. He was the one artist that really, like, surprised me to know, because I had been to so many shows before that, but he was the one artist that really completely surprised me how good he was live.
And remember when MTV came out, he had some great videos too. I mean, Dashboard was probably one of the most played videos. Every time you turned it on MTV, you would see Dashboard, and it was like this 30-minute like song, you know what I mean? But it was so much fun to watch. It really was. Case, you like Meatloaf. Casey is my girlfriend and our producer back there.
Hi, Casey.
When do you remember?
Hi, guys.
She's waving to you.
You just waved.
She doesn't realize her camera's there. There she is back there.
I'm in my hole. I have a friend tonight.
Say hi, Tiff. Lean in, Tiff. Say hello.
Lean on in.
Lean on in.
She's camera shy.
I would say my first Meatloaf, my mom, she is obsessed with Meatloaf. That's like her karaoke song. I think the only band t-shirt she might own is a Meatloaf band t-shirt.
Nice. Wow. Is she coming this weekend?
She was supposed to come last weekend, so she does owe me.
Well, and I think Meatloaf might be the show for her.
Meatloaf might be the one for her.
It might be the show
definitely.
And we can't not talk about "I'll Do Anything for Love" when you talk about Meatloaf. How big that song is! Video.
That's my mom's favorite.
Yes. Like it's in commercials.
Yeah, that's
everywhere.
That's the beginning of that too, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
Which is crazy because that's a sequel album that also went platinum.
There was actually three.
Bat Out of Hell went platinum, 15 times?
Did you know that there was a Bat Out of Hell 3?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we don't talk about it.
Yeah. I don't think it was.
No,
it's like The Godfather, dude. No, one and two.
That's that album. Around, we're like, all right. Meatloaf, we love you, buddy, but why? Why? Why?
I was amazed at when some of the albums were released when I was going back and looking, and I was like, wait a minute. That's like. Like well within my lifetime.
Oh, absolutely. You know?
And
yeah,
I didn't realize a lot of them, like especially Bat 2 was like
that was
90s.
High school.
Yeah, that was 90s.
Like, shit, why did I not realize
all of it
that?
Is a lot for yeah.
Yeah, it's a
honestly,
lot further.
Yeah, it was new to I can remember her jamming into the car. Like it was new.
Yeah.
And thinking
you
it was
young,
new showing it, but it's not.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah.
So where are you guys all from New York? Are you all from Queens and Long Island and all those areas or
yeah.
Oh, okay. So the whole band is New York based.
Yeah,
mainly Long Island.
Right, that's where I was born and raised back in the day. Now I'm a New York. I'm from New York originally. Well, my family all came from upstate in the Orange County area. It's called Monroe.
Sure.
Monroe's a beautiful area up there. And then of course I went to NYU and I lived in the city for a long time. And we had some of my other aunts that lived in areas of the city as well. So. But and Long Island.
Speaking of Long Island, I think there is a fellow Long Islander named Guy that would like to tune in for a second.
Throw his ass on. And also, Casey went to school in Long Island to CW Post. It is now called something else. I don't know what the hell it's
called. It's just LIU.
Yeah, LIU. So she went to Casey went to Long Island University where she was a field hockey player that went to three championships, NCAA championships. No, we won't say that she lost them all.
Yes, I am. I am a professional runner-up.
She's the Bill.
A professional runner-up.
She's the Bill.
In my family at home, we call
that's
it first place
that's
loser.
True. She's the Bill.
But,
Guy, what's going on? We can't see you, man. You're
unmute.
A little white thing.
Yeah, unmute for us, Guy.
Are you there, Guy?
Can you unmute him?
Hello. Hello. Guy, you're muted.
Oh, no.
And we can't see
Bruce
your face. There you are. What's going on, brother?
What's going on? How's everybody doing?
What's going on, buddy?
Hello.
Hey, just hanging. I'm watching the podcast. Aren't these girls great?
They said Guy was coming on.
I was trying to get Guy. He's like right in the middle of something because I'm saying, go on. And he said, I can't do it right now. So I said, all right, I'll go
on. Well, you popped on. I'm like, Jesus Christ, you look just like him.
Oh, it's a party.
Look at that. Party. What's up, Guy?
Yo, what's up?
Now it's a party.
We were just saying how every band you guys bring in is absolutely a stellar act, and we know for sure that this band is going to be the next stellar act that comes on our stage, and we can't wait, man.
Oh, yeah. That band's awesome.
Now, you guys have seen the band,
many
correct?
Times. I've had them play. Yeah, we played. Had them play at different shows. I've seen them plenty of times. Great band.
Anything? So are you guys playing anything? So where, like, I guess what my question is you've seen them play before, and they got some comedy, some antics like that. How close to that Meatloaf feel do you feel when you see these guys play?
Oh, you definitely feel it. I mean, they got the look, they got the sound down, you know, it's definitely, they got the whole package.
Yeah, and that's what we were just talking about, the simple fact that, you know, it doesn't, like we were saying, like, Bat is out there, and they're still out there making music, you know, Meatloaf is no longer with us, of course, but, you know, they're out there, you know, playing, but, you know, you can get musicians any day. You need that front guy, man. Mm-hmm. You need somebody out front that gives you the experience of Meatloaf, you know?
Definitely.
And
John does. John brings it. You're going to be looking at him and say, geez, this guy's really putting his whole heart and soul into it. And he really is phenomenal. He
definitely does.
Well, yeah. we know that we got to bring him donuts. Normally, everybody brings us. And by the way, I just want to make sure.
Bagels, right?
Yeah, I want to make sure you girls know that most of the time, you know, people from New York bring us bagels.
Yeah, I heard about that.
And that's Bagel Bruce.
It's the greatest thing you guys ever did.
I'm sorry, I apologize.
We'll see what we can do.
Yeah,
well, you got to remember, you got another Queens couple here. So, you know, we had a battle between Queens and Long Island bagels, and I do believe maybe Queens won that. Did
we had to make two separate categories.
Yeah. Oh, that's right.
I don't know. Long Island bagels are pretty good too.
Well, I don't know. You got to go to Bagel Oasis.
There's a different spot. Everybody's got
where
a different
the Who
spot.
Guys get their bagels from? Because they were good.
We love Bagel Boss and Long Island Bagel Cafe are the two big ones.
Bagel Boss. Bagel Boss.
Yeah.
I love Bagel Boss. We are best friends. It has already happened. I turned myself
on. You lit her
on
fire, girlfriend.
Because I love Bagel Boss. There is a bagel at Bagel Boss named after me and my friends. It's called The Originator. It is you can get it whatever type of bagel you want. We start with plain because that's the basic. So plain, inside, scooped out.
No, don't fucking toasted, stop with the scooping shit.
Light butter,
stop
light cream
with the
cheese,
scooping shit. Turn the fucking camera
eggs,
off.
Sliced on the inside.
Don't knock it till you try it.
The Originator Bagel Boss. Ooh.
Let me tell you something. Oh, yeah. I don't know if you guys have seen it, but there was a guy. He did a thing on Instagram, and it was probably one of the greatest things I ever saw. He was downtown in Manhattan, and he walked into a place, and he was there visiting. And it all came from his friend. It was actually the phone interview his friend recorded. And he said, hey, man, he goes, do me a favor. Tell me again what you just told me. And they show the video of the guy. And he goes, dude, I'm on my way back to L.A. I'm in the airport. He goes, I thought you were in New York. He goes, no, they threw me out of New York. He goes, what do you mean? This is a true story. The guy says, what are you talking about? He goes, I walked into a bagel place and I asked for a scoop bagel. And the guy said, get the fuck out of New York. He said the guy bought him a ticket, got him an Uber, took him to the airport and said, leave the city and don't ever come back. And the guy was at, and you can watch the video online. And he's literally going, I'm at the airport. I don't know what to do. They brought me here and they told me to get out of New York.
If you're in Queens, did you just say Lion's Cookies?
Who?
Lion's Cookies.
What the hell's Lion's Cookies?
From Queens?
You on crack? No.
Yes, but that's besides the point.
Yeah. But you got to go look up the video. It's the guy who got thrown out of New York for a scoop bagel. It's hilarious. It's absolutely, and it's a true story. And he was at the airport scared. Like he was afraid to go back to New York because he thought he was getting really thrown out of New York. It was a hilarious story.
Because that guy determines all of New York.
Yeah. Yeah, right. You scoop a bagel. Yeah, I'm with him 100%.
He's the bagel police.
I would have paid half the ticket.
I don't even know what a scoop bagel is.
It's what you do when your fucking brain doesn't work.
Are you just scooping the bread out of it?
Yeah. What the hell? Why would you do that?
I don't know.
It's the best
part. You can put stuff inside it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know what? You can put stuff inside it without taking the insides out of it.
That's it.
You just got to squeeze harder.
Yeah. I mean, look, they did scoop Meatloaf. Remember back in Rocky Horror, they put him in a table. He got scooped out, right? That's what you two people do best.
I will say the equivalent of that for us down here, you know, like outside of Philly, is a scooped hoagie. Scooping the roll for a hoagie, you know, whether or not you like that.
But that I'm okay
from
with.
Here and I have never
that's
heard
okay no, because no, it's bread.
Scoop. I've seen that.
It's just fucking bread. It's not a bagel.
Yep.
I mean, don't get me wrong.
Well, if you're trying to go light on your gluten intake, it's a good one. Still eat a bagel.
Hey, man, Deadpool removed all the gluten from the earth. It's not even here anymore. Gluten's gone. But hey,
we are now gluten-free.
We are a gluten-free society now.
Oh, Lord.
But no, look, we are so excited for this show. We really are, man. We love Meat Loaf. Like I said, he was a wonderful human being. He's done some amazing work. His career was something that is timeless. Again, you need to watch Roadie. You gotta see Meat Loaf in all his glory. And with Alice Cooper and Deborah Harry and all those people, it's such a good movie, such a great soundtrack. I am so excited to have this band here. This is going to be a good show.
Man. You guys are
walking into a place you've never been to before. Trust me, Bruce, you've seen a couple shows here. You know what we do.
It's like nothing I've seen anywhere else. I mean, some venues claim they have a great sound system, but you guys have the best sound system ever. And whatever else
you do
with the lights and all the things that you do off the walls, the colors, the pictures. It's like I'm back in the 60s. I'm seeing the colors, man.
You know? Yeah. You're here all day. Barbara said, don't forget all the incredible. Wait, now let's talk about costumes. So how many costume changes do you have?
Six to seven.
Six to seven. That's
so what do you go through? I'm sure there's got to be an Eddie costume, right? For
of course.
Yeah. That's awesome. Then I'm magenta.
Do you really change to magenta? That's hilarious.
That's great.
See, I don't have the curly hair, but I do the whole, you know, the maid outfit.
You know, and there's a cheerleading costume for Paradise. You know,
we do Angel and Devil for one song.
Oh, nice. Sweet. And then he's got to do the flowing white outfit, like I call it the puffy shirt, like Seinfeld.
He does that one.
Gotta do that. I tell you, right? They do a song. What is it? Heaven Can Wait.
Yeah.
The bubbles. Do you still use the bubbles?
We do the bubbles. Yeah, and if we're allowed, unless we're told we can't do it.
When I saw that, I was really touched by it. You know, it was like every life is a bubble.
And Case, you keep putting that thing up. Will you pay attention, please? Take that thing down, whatever that is. You put up 100 times. Thank you. Anyway, bubbles.
Yes.
You were touched by a bubble. That sounds like some shit you probably shouldn't tell people online, bro. I'm just being straight up with
Remember your prime directive, Ranger. The bubbles represent all the people that we have lost in our lives. And it left a lump in my throat to watch it the first time I saw it. So it was really incredible.
You know what leaves a lump in my throat? A scoop fucking bagel.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that's what leaves a lump in my throat.
Don't even judge the originator. If you would taste the originator once,
I'll kick the originator right in their
scoop. You would die for it, baby.
But look, girls, I am so – thank you guys for coming on. And your husband who's hiding over there. Thank you for having us.
Hold on.
Hey, yo, guys. What's going on, brother?
My husband's here, too.
Thank you, guys. How you doing, Joe?
We got these great-looking guys, these great-looking girls. Now, let me tell you, does he dress in a cat suit, the other husband?
No.
Don't give it away.
Anything for a price.
Anything for a price.
Come on in.
Come in, Joe.
Yeah, people. Hey, thank you, Joe. Look, people love to see the band. They love to see you guys. We do. We get thousands of people by the end of the week that will watch this podcast, and they really like seeing the bands. And they like getting to know you, and it's great not only for us but for, you know, even future gigs. They get to see you guys and see who you are as people and understand. So you guys. Mm-hmm. Why don't you? Let's start with John. Nick. Let's start with Nick. Nick, why Meatloaf? Like, what got you into Meatloaf? And
I'm gonna go way back, dudes. Way back. I'm a big Todd Rundgren fan, and
I love Todd Rundgren, man.
All of the albums that he produced, and then somebody came to me one day and goes, Todd just produced this crazy album. I'm like, what? What are you talking about? Meat Loaf. I'm like, get the fuck out of here. What are you talking about? Put the album on, and I just sat there and said, holy shit, what an album. And that just started it for me. And I got into the whole head of Meat Loaf. And Todd sealed it for me, but Meat Loaf, what he did with Steinman is phenomenal. I thought
it was a great
combination, man. But by the way, hey, Guy. Hey, Bruce.
Hey. They're maxing. All right, let's go. What brought you into Meat Loaf? Where'd it come from?
For me, older brother, listening to Meat Loaf albums, heard Paradise, was like, what the hell is that? That's amazing. And then picked up more listening to over the years. And then, believe it or not, the band that we were in before this, we did it as a cover. I just loved it after that. I mean, and the way this band does the material, outstanding.
Yes.
Yeah. That's awesome. And I love that you know your wife's out front doing the thing. What was the girl's name that was in? Do you remember who's the girl's name that was
Patty
in
Russo.
The? Yes, that's it. Yes. Patty Russo. Especially in the video, she was gorgeous, man.
Oh yeah,
absolutely beautiful. Especially when she was all dressed in the white and everything.
Great at the part.
Yeah, you know, absolutely.
That's the biggest thing. You know, she played along with all that, the little cat and mouse things that they would do.
Yeah, you have to. You have to sell that. Yeah. He was very theatrical. I mean, he was probably one of the. You know, I was always big. I know you guys remember the 80s. These guys didn't see a lot of concerts, but theatrics were huge back then. I mean, when you went to see a concert, you saw a concert. ELO would come out in a spaceship. You know what I mean? Everybody, I remember seeing Twisted Sister, okay? Don't ask why. I wanted to see Dokken. Dokken opened up for Twisted Sister, which, by the way, we have a Dokken tribute coming up.
Yes.
Dokken opened up for Twisted Sister, and Twisted Sister had this huge set. It was New York City. Dee Snider comes out of a manhole cover. The drummer comes out of a car, like a burning car on stage. I'm like, theatrics, man. Mm-hmm. And they stopped. You know, some of those shows were so much fun just to go see. Styx, who
tubes.
Were just in the house.
The Tubes.
The tubes
out of their minds.
They were amazing. We had, what's his name from the Tubes here? Remember with the
Abel.
Yeah. No, who do we have from the Tubes? Remember the guy from the one prog band was here. He played with the Tubes. He was really awesome.
From Projects.
Yeah, but we've had members of all kinds of bands here. We just had Styx here rehearsing for their tour this past week. And it's like, you know, you talk about another band who used to do theatrics. I remember Paradise Theater in the 80s. Yeah. Dude, what a show.
Yeah.
You know, and that's one of the things I love about Meat Loaf is I love the theatrics.
Well, this show definitely has a Broadway flair.
Yeah.
It's pretty theatrical.
When we say Spellbound, we mean it.
Oh, hell yeah. What are you saying, Case?
So I guess I have sort of a question. Like, do you feel like it used to be a bigger production and you didn't mind paying for that price and now you're paying a larger price for a quarter of the production that you're getting at these big concerts?
I guess you could say that, but you know what? It's funny because the ticket prices go through the roof, but the bands do less. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, but it's expensive too. Production has changed. You know, it's very expensive now. It's not like it was back then.
Yes. It's no longer park hands. It's $25,000 movie rights, and there's a thousand of them.
Exactly.
You know?
You went from like Kiss was another one. Look at the theatrics of Kiss. I mean, all those bands back in the day used to really give you one hell of a show. Yes, man. When you saw Yes in concert, you're like, Rick Wakeman alone was a show to watch, you know?
I got to give Joe props because Joe's done a lot of our AV and he's added to our show immensely. So just a little bit has gone such a long way when people see what goes on behind us.
Oh, you haven't been here yet, my friend.
I'm looking forward to it. Right?
I can't wait. Oh, my God.
I'm going to kick your brain.
When you see some of the shit that goes on here, it's going to blow your mind. I don't know if you just saw any of the Starman clips that came in.
You know what, guys? I don't see shit because I'm playing the drums and everything's behind me.
Oh, no.
That's the good thing about here.
That's the problem. Yeah. Here, it's not. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
We don't
have a screen or a projector people plug into. We have what's called the mini sphere. We have projectors on the walls. We have stuff on the ceiling. We have stuff above you. We have screens above you, screens behind you. It is an all-encompassing room. It's not just the screen behind you showing pictures.
The drummer might have the best view now.
Yeah, you might have the best view because you're seeing what's going on surrounding the audience.
Wow.
And the audience has realized here, too, that sitting up front is great. But if you sit back, you literally get to go, what the hell is going on in my mind? I can't wait. We have a Grateful Dead tribute coming in.
Yeah.
And then if you like acid and you like the Grateful Dead, this is the place to take your acid.
We are your place.
Yes, it is.
I might stay if you
just don't screw it up.
The laser light show, Pink Floyd.
Oh yeah.
Planetarium.
Hey, do you have like a prop that could bring like a girl down into a song on stage?
We have the ability. We had a Tool tribute here and we had girls like actually up in the big circle thing dancing. We brought them down. We had
five, the rings, the silks and the
silks they had down. So yeah, we have the ability to put it up. We just don't have the mechanism. If you're brave, I got a guy that'll hold a rope for a little bit.
We also have mats.
We do have mats. If you hit hard, you know, you can bounce. We did have a guy. We had a Hell's a Poppin'. Were you here for that? Hell's a Poppin'? You were.
I didn't see
We had this show here. It was like a sideshow called Hell's a Poppin'. And this guy was on like a 15-foot unicycle. Mm-hmm. And he fell off the unicycle. And man, when he hit, he bounced and he landed on his pack or that was on his back. And I'll tell you, he had a black and blue on his back like this. But I mean, that's what these guys do. They're eating swords. They're doing all kinds of crazy, sticking shit up their nose. But this guy literally fell. And so you do not want to fall from that height. I saw it happen. And the crowd was like, yay. They thought it was supposed to do it until he saw a tear come out of his eye. And he went, no.
You see how high that guy bounced? That was awesome.
Yeah, exactly.
We thought at first that it was like part of the gag. And then we were like, oh no.
He needs some milk.
The guy
he needs some milk. But we're great. So, and what I like too is so when a band does come here for the first time, we kind of get a really good feel for them. And then when they come back, if there is something special we can do like that, we're always open to doing it.
Oh,
you know what I mean? We actually do have, we have, you know, certain things that we can always do. But like I said, it's a different venue. Like I said, it's not what you're used to. It is like the Sphere in Vegas. We were doing it before they opened.
Yeah.
So it's pretty cool when you see it. We have like $60,000 projectors that project on all the walls. It's pretty freaking crazy.
Okay, and I'm sold. I'm coming. I'm coming.
I'm telling you, it is no, made.
You're convinced
there with bagels.
It's made for shows like this. It's made for shows like this.
So Nick, you need to throw a drumstick at me if I lose concentration because I'm seeing everything going on.
It'll be in 3D, Joe. You'll see it coming three times.
Who do we have here? The one time was it? It was Quiet Riot. Mm-hmm. And now that's before we had the sides. And I made all my money in film and TV. It's what I do. I got some awards for it, some pretty prestigious awards. And they spent more time turned around watching the screen than they did performing. And then afterwards, they came up to us and he went, "Can I buy that and take it on tour?" And I'm like, no, I do it live.
Most of the national acts do that to you.
Yeah.
But we have them all come in now. Striper comes in. We do even the Dead Daisies, I don't know if you're familiar with the Dead Daisies.
Sure, but absolutely.
Yeah, they were very meticulous until David said, you know what? Fuck that, man. You guys do it. Mm-hmm. I mean, because we love music and we know music. It's not like, oh, this guy's a Bowie fan. What the hell does he know about, Meat Loaf?
Right.
We are very, very, especially Steve and I, we are crazy musician lovers, man. We love music. We play drums. We play guitar. We are musicians here. We understand, how the beat works in a song. We understand, crescendos. We understand music. So
we can count to four.
Yeah, we can count to four.
Sometimes. Four timing's real rough.
Sometimes.
Hey, start adding things together.
But I'm really excited to see what you guys got and what you can bring because this is going to be one hell of a show. I'm telling you, it's going to be a lot of fun.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
I can't wait to meet John.
John's a trip.
Yeah.
What's that? He's What'd you great. Say?
You're going to love him.
Is he muted on the bottom?
I don't know. Are you Guy, are you just not talking or are you muted?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you now.
I hear on the
right. You guys are just talking so much, so I'm just letting you know.
We're just looking at your pretty face down there, baby.
Yeah. Ninja. He hides in the corner until he comes out.
Well, Guy has yet to come down to our venue and watch a show, although he's booking a lot of really great acts, I got to admit.
I'm just listening. You're making me want to come down and listen to all the good stuff about the place.
Return for the bagels.
Let me tell you something, though. This is one of the bands you want to come down for because, again, this is a theatrical band. It lends to what we do best on our side.
Correct.
And that's why I said, you got James Taylor. I mean, what the hell are you going to do with screens on a wall with James Taylor?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, what do? You
sparkly
know?
Shit.
Yeah, you do sparkly shit. You go,
a lot of trees in the background. A lot of trees. Right.
Exactly, yeah.
It was a gorgeous show.
It was.
Yeah, it was a beautiful show, major.
I changed lights around a little bit. You changed the video around a little bit.
And you're like, hey, okay. And we stayed awake. Cool. No, but they were a great band.
They were fantastic, man. But I really did.
They were. I was blown away by James Taylor, dude. But this is a band that lends to the theatrics of what we do best here at the Landis, in which our motto is actually experience differently. Because we have people that you're going to find out that are going to come to your show that just come to every freaking show we do.
Yes.
They don't care who's playing. They're like, dude, I just got to go see a show. And they come here. And we're trying to, we keep our ticket prices down. We have no fees. We don't add extra fees and taxes. If you buy a $20 ticket, it's $20. You buy a $30 ticket, it's $30. I mean, we're, you know, we try to, we know where the economy is. We know where the world is right now. So we're trying to get people out to see live music. We're trying to get people out to see bands like you and absolutely enjoy themselves and the venue that we've created here. So.
Well, we appreciate that.
Yeah, we appreciate that you guys do that. That's
and,
awesome.
And thanks so for doing it for us. Really, thank you.
Of course.
I'm telling you, I'm excited because, like I said, one of the things that, you know, it's a theatrical show and it's going to be theatrical. Like I said, there's literally things above your head that you won't see until you I would recommend bringing a camera to set up in the back so you can most bands bring a camera. They set it up in the back in our booth. We have a little space for you so you can get a little bit of a video of the show and kind of get an idea of what everything looked like. Okay, and use that. Use that to promote because, you're getting, you're gonna. It gets pretty intense in here sometimes. Yeah,
it does.
Yeah, especially depending on the band. Like again, the Who. We just had again these guys just booked a, you know, Who's Next here this past weekend, and man, they blew it away. And you know, the Who is one of those bands. You know, it's like, what do you do for the Who? Well, I go back and I went back into the 60s. I pulled, you know, generational footage from the 60s.
Yeah.
And these guys were done. They're like, dude, I don't even know what's going on the walls. He goes, but that was so fucking cool, man. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah, but it lends to the Who, you know?
Yeah, we
to,
knew. We met Billy a while ago.
Oh, they're so they're good, man.
They're so good.
Past bands, yeah.
Cool. What a great tribute to the Who. I mean, again, Guy and Bruce, I can't thank you guys enough for the amazing bands that you're sending down here. And a lot of them, of course, from New York. Our last tribute for, I think, Meat Loaf was from down south, weren't they?
Oh, I don't remember where they were from. Now.
We had one PA? Here from Los Angeles, and then the other one...
Pennsylvania?
Well, you guys said California.
No, L.A.
No, the first one was from
They were
LA.
Both from L.A.?
The second one, I don't think, was.
I think second one was from Pennsylvania.
All right.
Well, we only represent L.A., New York,
Pennsylvania.
So.
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you, man, there is a lot of great musicians and a lot of great artists out of New York. You know, New York and New Jersey is known for some of the great talent that's come out of these. And what happens is you get overshadowed by those big names, you know, and people don't realize that there's great musicians like you guys here, too. And that's kind of what we want to do. We want people to see that. You know, I got millions invested in this place. I'm probably never going to see that back. But as long as people get to see you and we get to open the doors and show people musicians like you who you're not in Bat. But, you know, you're probably better than Pat. You know, we get a lot of bands here, national acts, you know, that come in and they're like, oh, yeah, you know, we're so-and-so. I don't know. I don't want to name any right off the bat, but but you know, the only guy left is like the original roadie, you know, that used to stack the pieces. And he's 79 years old now, you know. And I'm like, but you're not that band anymore, you know.
So many bands like that.
Oh, there's so many. But I like it because they're touring and they're out there, you know. Yeah. But, you know, a lot of them overpriced themselves is the problem, too. I'm like, bro, you're a glorified version of that band. They're not even around anymore. Who did we have that was great? Remember the one Shirley something's Humble Pie?
Humble Pie.
Oh, yeah.
We had I love Humble Pie.
Jerry but, Shirley.
Yeah, Jerry Shirley.
So we had Jerry Shirley's version of Humble Pie here. Right? Yeah. Well, ain't no Humble them well. Pie left. There's nobody left.
Nobody. Zero.
Exactly. Yep. But the band that showed up were so good, man.
They were
absolutely. Yeah. I'm like, they were better than Humble Pie.
Yeah,
the drummer so Bobby's a friend of mine, Bobby Marks.
Oh man, what a great band, man.
Bobby's killer.
Oh, so good, man. But again, there's nobody from Humble Pie, so people don't want to buy tickets because they know it's not Humble Pie. So we got to try and how do we sell that to people? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm. It's a tough sell to people, but we work hard at it and we try.
Well, we're going to try to make you guys proud and make you feel like your investment was worth it.
Well, when on your way down, keep an eye out for those digital billboards because you'll be on there. You know, we really pushed the show hard. So, I'm excited to have you. It is you want to put their tag. It is all revved up. The ultimate Meat Loaf tribute. Everyone watching and all those people that watch this week. Right here at the Landis Theater in Vineland, New Jersey, March 29th, 8 p.m. Doors open at 7. Tickets are still on sale. We'll definitely have tickets at the door. I'm so excited over this band. Dude, that's a great picture of you guys, too. Look at that.
Thank you.
Even the still looks like, you know, like you guys are together and you're not with the guitar player.
Yes. Yeah. I'm still great sometimes. And they're all going like, you guys are great. And I'm like, yeah, how you doing?
Yeah. 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 Joe and I usually hang out and eat a brajol or ganoli, you know.
They're doing a meet and greet and I'm breaking down nonsense in the back.
No, man, you especially when it comes to Meatloaf. I mean, the band is so intricate.
And that's important. See, that's the most important thing we have is the chemistry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's what makes the show.
Yeah. You got to have that, especially with a band like this. Again, it is this Friday. It is the 29th. It is at 7:00. The doors will open. 8 p.m. The show starts. It's all revved up. And I'm going to tell you, it's the ultimate Meatloaf tribute. I want to change it to the ultimate Meatloaf experience because I feel like after watching some of the videos, this is going to be experiencing Meat back where he, you know, where we all know him from, and you know, God rest his soul, man. But he was a very strange but wonderful, loving fellow. He was a very loving fellow too.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah, he was.
I got a hug from Meatloaf, and I thought my back was going to snap. And I was like, is it his meds or is it just the way he is squeezing the shit out of me right now, like literally. But God rest his soul, and hey, thank you guys so much for keeping his amazing music, you know, alive and coming here to the Landis, and I can't wait. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Thank you so much. Thank you so
Absolutely. Guy, Bruce, thank you for coming on as well.
Thanks, everybody.
We got a lot of great bands coming up from you guys, and we will be announcing them all soon. Go to the Landis Theater with an ER.com, and you can see a lot of these amazing acts. Again, we just signed a couple new people. Again, the Dead Daisies are on the way back. We you know, unfortunately, Styx was here for a private concert for us. That was amazing.
I was grocery shopping,
dude. Yeah,
Casey, yeah, you were.
Casey
yeah.
was out I grocery shopping with them all day to fill their buses full of shit. Man, those guys eat everything.
I
man.
Know
Holy
exactly
crap.
All of their preferences on snacks. It's so amazing,
but that's the kind of venue you're coming to. You're coming to a venue where you know some of the biggest bands in the world just want to come here and just rehearse. You know, because they know it's a great place that they sound really good, and you know they can get in, they can get out, and you know they're safe, and you know we take good care of everyone here. So
again, looking forward to it, guys. Can't wait to meet you.
Thank you.
I can't wait to meet you guys either. And look, we got the donuts, you got the bagels. We're all in business here.
Maybe I'll bring some cannolis from New York.
Oh yes. Hey.
Now we're in.
Now,
all right. I guess I'm coming.
Let me tell you, because that's something I want to challenge. Because let me tell you something about South Philly area. I will tell you, I've been down here for a while, and he grew up in South Philly. There's a lot of Italians in South Philly.
Ray's got the accent on.
And I will tell you, they make some damn good cannolis down here. So I definitely would like to try that.
A North End Austin cannoli. You got
to go to Mario's and bring you some.
Oh, I'm going to have to try that. Look, and let me tell you something. I'm one of those guys that's really got a taste. So like, yes. like a couple dozen. You know what I'm saying?
Can't eat
cannoli then.
Drop off the cannoli.
You get one cannoli, you're like, yeah, I couldn't taste that. You know, I'm not sure.
Bring on the cannolis.
Thank you guys. We really do. You seem like wonderful people, and it's something that we enjoy here. We just like having good people in the house, and it makes for a good show and a good environment for everyone. So
thank you.
Safe travels. Be careful getting here, and we shall see you Friday.
Yes.
Thanks.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Good night, guys. Again, all revved up. The ultimate Meatloaf tribute, March 29th, this Friday, 7:00. The doors open, 8 p.m. Tickets are on sale now. Remember, there's no fees. There's no taxes. Well, there are taxes. We just pay those.
And parking is free.
Oh, we got free parking. We have a lot of free parking. We have absolute vodka
free
drinks available.
Free lighted parking, too.
Yes, we have. Oh, Steve actually put the intense LED lights into our parking lot.
Shout out to my dad.
Yeah, his dad's a LED light master. Mm-hmm. And Steve, like, really lit this place up, man. Yes. Yeah, you did lights all over.
Oddly
outside,
enough,
inside.
We're both lighting guys. In
outside,
just two
inside.
Very different ways. Yeah. Oh, all over the place we've done.
Wait till the little one grows up.
Oh, oddly enough, he is not senior. He is junior.
Right. He is the junior, the third. I knew that. I'm so sorry. Yep.
My license doesn't say that, though, because they weren't smart enough to put that on my birth certificate. So
you're so see, we thought you were
my mailing address is always gonna be the same as my dad's.
You'll always be a number two.
I am stuck.
Yeah. So, to let you guys know, third. You know how I would normally
cool,
do
third at the end of your name.
It is.
That is cool. Normally, I would do some trivia. I actually got some interesting Meatloaf facts. I didn't do trivia, but I thought these were interesting. That he once picked up a hitchhiker on Sunset Boulevard, and that hitchhiker was Charles Manson.
Oh, shit.
I did know that. Isn't that crazy? I did know that. Oh, I did the same thing, but it wasn't Charles Manson.
And he had a collection of over 100.
Just a hooker.
I'm not going to ask how that ended up.
Yeah, it was not good.
He looked similar. He looked like Marilyn Manson.
She looked like Charles Manson.
Oh, God. Big old.
There is some ribs
with
missing.
The X on the head.
Yes. What else you got there? Anything good?
He had a rubber ducky collection of over 100 ducks. That was like his prize collection.
Dude, I believe that.
I could see it. Yeah.
He was almost, this I thought was really cool. He was almost cast as Quasimodo, the voice of Quasimodo in Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Now,
the
Disney I would have fucking loved that.
Oh, wow.
I would have loved that. That's one of my favorite old Disney movies.
And he had to keep
I'd
an
say
oxygen
old,
mask.
It's the fucking, the same age I am. I can't even say old.
Wait, what's his oxygen mask?
He had to keep an oxygen mask backstage for the Bat Out of Hell tour.
Oh, dude, he had to keep an oxygen mask on the show. Yeah, he was. Yeah, like you said, he wasn't in the best of shape, and but man,
you could be in shape, and it would still possibly require an oxygen.
Yeah, I need oxygen right now, to be honest with you.
You should get one of those little boost things.
Oh man,
I used to use those all the time, man. I went through a phase where, man, I was huffing those things down. Oxygen, pure
oxygen.
You'll be like,
what's in that oxygen?
You don't realize it until you're like you're doing stuff and you're working, and you're like, oh, look at that, pure oxygen, man. That's crazy.
Oh my God, you want
to
go?
They used to sell it at Sports Authority.
Do we have our next guys on yet, Case?
We have Shane on.
Well, why don't we hit our Steve with that first this read here, Steve.
Oh, well, that's read three.
Yeah, I want to knock that one out right now before these guys come on, so we can knock that out of the way.
All right, we are doing the Capital Canine Association fundraiser, Casey. If you want to take a second to get that one up. Help protect the pups that protect you. Fundraising to provide ballistic and protective gear for police canines.
Fuck yeah. What a good cause, man.
April 14th from 12 to 6 p.m. Tickets are only $25, and the proceeds go directly towards helping the dogs. And that features Night's Rain and Reese, as well as a bunch of other people.
That's going to be a fun show.
That's a big show.
There's Carrie's butt up there.
Oh, wow.
Carrie put this together. Carrie put this together.
One, two, three, four, five.
Yeah, a lot of them are just acoustic acts. Seven. They're like.
That is $25 for 8 different performances.
That's not so bad, man.
That is
not so bad.
What are we thinking? What are we thinking? These prices are crazy. I feel like a car salesman.
Was that Crazy Eddie?
Crazy Eddie, yeah.
Our prices are insane.
Oh, we're insane.
What
was the oh my God, the Star Wars Family Guy episode where it was the intergalactic space droid salesman guy?
Forgot
these
about
deals
that.
Are good for you. That's us. 8 bands, $25. That's April 14th from 12 to 6 p.m. The Capital Canine Association fundraiser.
And what a good cause, man. Yes. I mean, you know, we're big dog people. And this is, you know, these dogs are a big part of the police force. They're a big part. When I was in the Army, dogs were a big part of the Army. You know, they're a big part of our lives. You know what I mean? And here's a way to give back to, you know, protect them. Because, you know, these criminals. And look, I'm going to tell you, you say what you want to say. You know, a lot of us have our carry concealed permits for a reason. This country has gone to shit, and these dogs, these people that do this shit, they don't care. They don't care that they're going to shoot a dog, you know, but these dogs deserve our protection as well. They deserve us to take care of them. And this is a great way to give back because bulletproof vests are expensive to begin with. But when you got to get them for that, like outfitted to fit a dog, cause they can't be a heavy, they have to be a lightweight material, which is a very expensive type of protection from bullets. And these are good vests. I mean, you're talking 9mm shotgun. They really do stop some serious, you know, caliber rounds. And these dogs deserve, you know, anything we can give to them.
Hey, I like dogs more than I like most people. So
yeah. I agree. And you're not just giving up $25. This is $25 for 8 bands in a day to come.
You have your smart criminal.
Like,
you just shoot low, take
can't
a little
wait till
leg.
Bob hears that.
Out of
I can't
too,
wait.
You know?
Can't wait.
Come rock out a little bit.
Steve didn't hear that.
I think I did.
No, we love dogs. We you know, we also have a Greyhound event we take on every year. And I think this is a wonderful cause. Very, very wonderful cause to protect these dogs that protect us. I think it's awesome. So that's April 14th. I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. And do we have some rock and docking guy or two or three
we
or
do.
None?
We do. We have Shane on.
Shane's on. Let's bring Shane on. Yeah, fuck it, man.
Yeah, there you go.
Shane.
Hey guys, how's it going?
Well, with the Rockstar Revolution. I forgot they got another band opening up, man. Revolution. So this is Shane. Where you at, Shane? All I can see is this. Shane, what's going on, bro? Look at that shirt. It's about time somebody wore a good shirt.
Nice shirt.
Look at this guy over here, man. He's dressed like a fucking, I don't know what that is over there.
But yeah, I don't know why this shirt, I don't like it, but sort of seems that all the girls do like it.
Well, I like it, and I'm not a girl. Well, then again, it's 2024. I don't know yet. I haven't decided.
Gabe is from Rockstar Revolution.
Oh, you're from Rockstar Revolution.
Shane is from Rockin'. Gabe, yep. The comment is from Rockstar
Revolution. Oh, Gabe is, dude, you're confusing the shit out of it. So, Shane, what in the band, what do you play an instrument? Do you sing? Where are you at in the band?
I'm the actual singer. So I'm actually,
shit.
My stage name is Ron Rockin.
Oh, so you're the Don Dokken of the band.
Yeah,
that's awesome. Yeah, Don is kind of lost.
Ron Rockin.
Don is not the Don Dokken of the days, man. We were just talking to the other band on before you. And I literally went to see Twisted Sister years ago, like almost right before I went in the military. Just to see Dokken open up, and half the crowd was like, "All right, Dokken," and they left. You know, what I mean, no offense to Twisted Sister, because you know I've stayed for the show, but Dokken, man, I've always been a fan. I know, I think you know George Lynch has been here. He's on his way back with the Lynch Mob, and you know George is a phenomenal guitar player. While they were here, they did a lot of Dokken tunes.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah, they really, you know, and George is just, dude, he's just such a stellar guitar player, man. And to be able to have him here on our stage is phenomenal. And his final tour is coming through. So,
I know some of the guys in the Lynch Mob, and I know some of the guys from Dokken. So they all know about us.
Well, I've heard nothing but good things. So I'm excited because, again, I'm a big Dokken fan. And, again, I bought tickets just to see Dokken open up for bands, just so I could see Dokken before they were, you know, headlining, which is so cool, man. Why Dokken? What brought you to Dokken?
Well, actually, it's a funny story. I'm actually singing a Foreigner tribute as well and a Tesla tribute. So
there was
a Dokken tribute that was here in Dallas, and they were actually looking for a singer, and I didn't know about it. I was standing in the audience after, because we opened up for them from the Tesla tribute, and I was singing the Dokken stuff, and I was standing next to John Land, who's our George Lynch. I was standing next to his wife, and she's like, "You can sing this stuff." I'm like, "Yeah, this stuff is easier than the Tesla stuff."
It probably is.
In the 80s, I think my first album that I was really into was Beast from the East.
Oh yeah, great album, man.
Hell yeah.
Are you still with the other two bands? You still do the other two bands?
I still do the Foreigner stuff. I still do the Tesla stuff. I was actually in a Europe tribute as well. But Dallas has so many tribute bands that are stellar. It's almost like the capital of the world.
Yeah, well, we're finding that same thing out with New York, like Long Island. We got some stellar Long Island bands. There's these places that you don't realize. And we were just telling, you know, the tribute to Meat Loaf that's coming on Friday before you. You know, it's one of those, you guys are, people don't realize how good you are. You know, you didn't get that chance. You know, you didn't get that chance to be out there fronting the real Dokken. But, dude, this is, you're an amazing musician in your own. And it's so great that this thing that's come along in the last several years of experiences and tribute acts has given you guys a platform to come out and finally showcase, you know, what you're about. And that's what we're about here is giving you guys a place here, especially, you know, on the East Coast to really shine. And you know, it's your time to take the stage, man. And I'm excited,
man. One of the reasons why we're excited to come up there. We like playing to give back to the fans. If the fans weren't there, we couldn't be doing this.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And that's the way we look at it, man. And we want people to know you exist. We want people to see these bands. We want people to hear these bands. I mean, you know, there's only one George Lynch, you know, but dude, there's guys out there that have been playing his music since they were kids, and they're damn good guitar players, and they're not getting the chance, you know, because it's music has changed. You know what I mean? You can't get that opportunity like these guys had back in the day. You know, you just, no matter how good you are now, if you're not, you know, Taylor Swift, good fucking luck, you know? You know, and getting albums out. Rock just isn't what it was,
no,
you know?
Not at all.
And we sort of got a little bit of a reputation. We got hit up on YouTube. We had actually a video go viral on YouTube. So it's been out there for 7 months, and it has almost 133K views in seven months.
You should send that over to us, because we probably get, and we'll add that to that. We get about 5,000-6,000 views a week on our podcast. So, you know, we'd be happy to add that and have that as part of, so people can see it. That's awesome, man. And what is it a video of?
It's a video of a show here in Dallas that we did at a small local club. It was released on the same exact day that Don and the guys released their new single.
No.
So it was like every time somebody was viewing their single, they would get recommended to watch our video.
That's awesome, man. Dude, if you got to ride the coattails to get there, you got to do what you got to do, baby. Man. That's awesome, dude. I'm excited, man. So lineup wise, I mean, for the set list wise, I mean, you guys, are you doing basically all the hits? Do you throw all the hits in there and some B-sides?
We're doing all the hits and some B-sides. We did have to drop a couple of the hits because John's going through a issue that he can't gallop. He has some type of pinched nerve that he's trying to get over in his neck and his arm. So he's fighting that. But we do hit probably pretty much everybody's favorite tunes.
Yeah, I'm looking right now, and I would say so.
What's that?
There's the set list.
Oh, we're looking at the set list.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah. Don't give anything away.
No, I won't. But
I mean, but, you hit them. But you definitely
one,
hit them.
There's one song in there that I asked George to play when they come back. So that he never plays, and I'm excited that it just because
is it on our set list? We'll play it for you.
It is on your set list. It is, and I'm excited to see it because it's just one of those songs that look again. I was such a Dokken fan, man. I love Dokken. I mean, their music videos were great, you know. And it's a shame that you know Don just isn't what he is anymore, you know. And you know they went out there, they tried, but it was almost like Foreigner. You know, Foreigner's still out there. You know, going they're going on tour with Styx. You know, Styx was just here, you know, rehearsing. And when I tell you, man, Tommy and those guys sound phenomenal. I mean, you're looking at JY still sounds phenomenal. I mean, these guys are there. But you get a lot of these other bands, like, you know, Foreigner got a lot of shtick from their last tour saying, hey, man, you just don't sound like you.
They have no members. They have no original members.
Well, it's like fucking who was just out there? The Southern rock band, fucking
Leonard Skinner.
Leonard Skinner.
They had Leonard Skinner live at the Country Music Awards. I'm like, there's nobody there's from Leonard Skinner. It's a fucking glorified tribute act, man.
It's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
And for me, being someone that
I went grocery shopping with a roadie from Leonard Skinner.
You did. You actually did. You. Yeah, he's a cool dude, man. But the thing is, with I love Dokken so much that I want to see you. Because your band is going to give me the Dokken that I love. You're going to give me the Dokken that I grew up with. You're going to give me the Dokken that I remember. Mm-hmm. I don't want to see Dokken now. George Lynch is amazing. You know what I mean? He's not singing. Yeah. You know, he's doing what George does best. And it's like, I just want to see Dokken, and you can't anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys,
you'll be in for a treat.
I can't wait, man. But you guys give us that. That's what I love about when, you know, these... These bands, and
we sound like the 80s Dokken.
You're from Texas?
Yes. Well, originally from Pennsylvania. So I lived just outside of Tamaqua.
My grandparents.
That's where I grew up.
Yeah.
Oh, is that where they live up there?
That's we used to go camping there all the time.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah.
So are you in Texas now?
Yes.
So what do you guys do? Do you guys just travel and do a bunch of dates in a row and on the different coasts?
We'll set up different dates here and there, play around wherever we can. We do a lot of regional stuff here in Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas, Oklahoma, that type of stuff. But we do like to spread it around and go out. For us, it's not so much of the money. It's more of bringing happiness to people and playing the stuff that we like to play.
Oh, see, that's awesome. Yeah, well, we ain't about the money either. That's for damn sure.
Yeah, it's a similar boat.
I got so much money invested in this venue. Wait till you'll be happy when you come, because like I said, we really put our heart and soul. We got one of the best sound guys around. You know, we got one of the best lighting guys around. Our video guy's okay, but you know, he's the best. We really love music. We love bands like yours, and we're blown away, excited, man. And now is all the band from Texas?
Yep, all the bands from Texas. So, John, he's our George Lynch. He has the tone of George down pat. So it's nice. You'll be able to close your eyes and you'll think it's George. He used to play on the, actually still does. He plays on the World Series of Poker. He's Cowboy John Land.
Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I know exactly who he is.
Holy shit. Yep. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Get out of here. That's so cool, man. I definitely know not to play any fucking cards while
he's here. That's for sure. He just blew his cover.
That's for sure. Yep. He's like, shit. Yep.
Oh, and then we got Keith Long on bass. He does the Pilsen parts real good. He does the higher harmonies, but we also have a drummer, Jamie Northrup. He also does the higher harmony. So he's nice. He usually takes Pilsen's spot on the harmonies.
And you need that for Dokken. You got that. That's part of what made Dokken so great was those high harmonies and stuff.
Yep. And the team that we have sort of just all the pieces fit together that all our voices match all the harmonies that Dokken has.
Oh man, I cannot wait for the show.
I'm excited, man.
I am so excited for the show, dude. You have no idea. One of our best patrons on the planet, Joe Morrison, was just asking if you're doing anything from Tooth and Nail. You have to. How can you not do anything? You got to be doing half a Tooth and Nail. I mean,
most of the stuff is from Under Lock and Key and Tooth and Nail.
Yeah, that's two of the greatest albums they made. Tooth and Nail is just such a great album, man, from start to finish. But the song that I love isn't on either of those albums. Exactly, it's on a soundtrack, and yeah, I love that song, man.
I knew when I saw it.
A little story behind that one. I don't know if you guys know it, but that was sort of when Jeff and Lynch were sort of giving it to George. They wrote that song in a key he does not like to sing purposely. And that's why it's up there.
It is way up there. It was one of those, you know, I know Robert England very well. And I remember when we were sitting at a bar one time, we were talking about it. And he's like, I was like, man, I said, the only thing that got me into Freddy Krueger was Dream Warriors, man. I'm like, look, I watched the first movie. I said, but that third movie, dude, I said, you had the fucking best song in the world as well, technically the theme of it. It's more at the end, but it's like, dude, you got Dokken to do the song. And then the movie ends up being so fucking cool because at that point they had started getting, you know, visual effects, which is 10 times better than they had been for the first two films. And all he kept asking is, yeah, can you get me in a movie?
And we're gonna try and bring the 80s concert experience to you. So we're bringing, I think, a 35-foot truck of production with us.
Oh, fuck yeah, man. Absolutely, man. That's going to be – dude, I cannot wait, man. And so like
this,
I said –
this week I got to get with one of your guys for the production to make sure they know what's going on and make sure they're okay. Like, we're going to bring Cold Sparks, CO2 cannons.
CO2 cannons, yeah. Cold Spark, we got to check on.
Yeah,
we just got to talk to the fire marshal, make sure he's okay with it because they are very stickler.
1937, baby.
And I will tell you why, because there was a band called Great White back in the day.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, and they played here and they burnt down a building and it was not a very good time. So and it happened right here in this area. So they're still, you know, whenever we get fire on the stage or something, they're like, oh, I need to be there. So they got to stand on the side of the stage. And they don't understand what a cold spark machine is. All they know is sparks start fires, and that's all they care about. So, but we will ask about it because I have an inspection tomorrow. So I will ask.
It's good to hear that you guys have something that the drummer can see because it's hilarious. Our drummer, I'm on trying to get him out from behind the kit a little bit so everybody sees him because at least two or three times on every show, after the show, we like to go out and mingle with the crowd and talk to people and get their feedback and just mingle. And we'll be standing there and some girl will come up to us and start talking to us. And she'll give Jamie her camera and say, can you take a picture with me in the band?
That's
wow.
That is fucked up, man.
That sucks.
That is actually fucking hilarious, man. But I don't know if you've gone online and seen what we do here. Like, you know, we try to tell everybody we came up with the name the Mini Sphere. Like, we have an all encompassing room. Like, our walls, you know, get lit up and the videos everywhere and stuff's above you. And it really puts on. And again, Dokken was, you know, part of that theatrical, you know, rock and roll back in the day. You know, they put on one hell of a show. It wasn't just like, you know, a couple guys up there playing music. You know, they put on a show.
Yep.
And dude, I'm so excited. Again, everything, Tooth and Nail is such a great album. But mm-hmm. I when George was here, you know, I was like, man, I love Dream War. You got to play that song. So Jaron's trying to, you know.
That's awesome.
Jaron's trying to get him to play it this time, man. Which maybe that's why they don't play it, because he's like, I don't play that song. I wrote that to fuck with somebody. You know?
I don't even know if – I know Don doesn't play it too much because he'll play it every now and again, but it's up there. It's tough to sing. That's probably my hardest song to sing.
That might be a reason they don't do it. Well, when George was here, it was the longest show they had played. He normally cuts off at a certain time. But again, we had – when you come here and see everything we do, he was kind of mesmerized. And there was a point – remember the singer – what's the guy's name that sings for
– George Cologne.
Yeah, George
Gabriel.
Gabriel. Gabriel's his name. Gabriel's like he just needed a drink of water. He's like, I need a drink. And George was playing, and he's just sitting there like with a riff just going out of nowhere. And he looked over at Jaron and the drummer. He goes, you going to fucking join in or what? And they looked at each other like, I guess we're just going to make up a song as we go along here. And they mm-hmm. did. And, dude, I don't know what it was, but it was great. They just went off and did a little jazz number, rock and roll jazz number, man. It was freaking so good, man.
They did.
He's killer, man. And, again, I'm so happy to have had him here, have his final tour coming back, of course, and to be able to have a band like you guys that are going to bring – Dokken back to life for me as a band. You know, having George here is fucking amazing, man, because again, nobody plays like him, you know. And we've had some damn, you know, we're very lucky to have had some of the guitar players we've had on this stage.
Yeah, man.
You know, we really are. We've had some legends on our stage, man. We've had Rock and Roll Hall of Famers all, you know, on our stage. So but they're great, but their bands aren't great anymore. I don't mean that in a bad way. But again, Dokken's not Dokken.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I'm not going to pay to see Dokken. You know what I mean? Because I don't want to remember them that way. I want to pay to see these guys so I can remember Dokken the way I love Dokken.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah, that's why we do what we do.
You got any Dokken trivia?
Go back and relive the days.
I just wrote a couple of things down. Believe it or not, it was really hard to find things on Dokken. What year did Dokken form his – Don Dokken form his first band? What year do you think it was?
Shit. It had to be late 70s.
Mid-70s.
Mid-70s, okay.
1976.
What was the name of the band?
That I didn't write down.
You don't know that, do you, by any chance, what Don Dokken's first band was?
No, I don't. I don't know.
Yeah, that's funny. I didn't even know. I thought Dokken was his band.
And then I had, what year did Breaking the Chains debut?
Oh.
Airborne.
And that was the first
Airborne.
Born in 1976, named Airborne.
So his first, I was Airborne.
That's wild, because there was an Airborne band that came from Australia, the famous.
Yeah,
Airborne
band.
And
which
then,
is probably why he changed the name and said, "Let's just call it Dokken. Fuck it, they can't take that from me."
And he left it in 1978 to form Firefox with two X's,
which became Whitesnake.
Really?
Yes.
Oh.
What?
Yeah.
Firefox became Whitesnake.
Not Whitesnake. White Line.
Oh, White Line. That makes more sense. That makes more sense.
Became White Line. What year did Breaking the Chains debut? Their first album. Dokken's first album. What year do you
think? I have no idea.
1983.
Really?
And then they just came out with, I don't know if you guys were aware of this or not, they just came out with a new album this past October called Heaven Comes Down.
Yeah, called Just Don't See Me on Tour.
I'll tell you what. The new album isn't bad, but it's not...
No.
It's not... Legendary Dokken.
It's too modern.
You have to give it to Don, because he found a way to sing the same stuff a full octave lower than he normally sang it.
Yeah.
You know, you get to an age, you have to, you know.
I mean, David Coverdale's doing the same thing. I'm bringing up Whitesnake again, but David Coverdale's doing the same thing. Everybody's lowering it that
octave. David Coverdale is the only member of Whitesnake that has not played here.
Really?
Yeah. We've had the rest of Whitesnake has been on the stage in some band or some form. Some Joel Hoekstra just by himself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
He's coming back.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Joel will be back too. Yeah. He'll be back. That's going to be a great show. But yeah. So look, man, Shane, we are so excited to have you, man. It's great too, man, having a band out of Texas coming in, because it just goes to show there's so many great bands across the United States of America, man. And, you know, I'm a big patriot. Patriotic guy, man. You know, I fought for this country. I was in the military for some time. I spent time in Texas. I actually got my first tattoo at Fort in Texas at I was in Fort Sill, Oklahoma. We drove down to Wichita Falls, and I got my first tattoo in Wichita Falls, man. When I was 17 years old, because I went in a year before I graduated. Wow. I went in the military on the GI Bill a year before I graduated. Gotcha. Yeah. So
I'm stoked to be coming back, because it's sort of like a homecoming for me, because I don't get to play too many shows up in Pennsylvania, the tri-state area.
Do you have family here still?
Yep. All my brothers, sister, mom, they all live up there.
Are they coming to the show?
Yep.
Oh, great.
That is awesome.
I can tell you is I need that hat. Please sell those hats.
Make America rocking again.
Dude, that is the greatest hat ever, man. I love that hat, man. Do you guys have merch you're gonna have out here for us?
Yep, we'll have merch out there.
Oh, you got a truck that big, there gotta be some merch on there.
they're actually leaving. We're rehearsing Wednesday, loading up the truck, and they're leaving, I think, Thursday afternoon.
Oh, dude, this is going to be a hell of a show. We got to really blow this out and really get these, you know, see if we can fill these seats, because it's been tough in Jersey, because every Tuesday they tell everybody how Friday and Saturday it's going to rain really hard. So everybody's like, well, I'm not going to go out in that. And then come Friday and Saturday, it barely rains. And we're like, well, that would have been nice. We could have sold a ticket. You know, if you didn't tell people on Tuesday about the weather on fucking Friday.
Which I still don't understand how that messes us up, because we're indoors. We have gotten calls whether the building will be open in the rain.
People are afraid to drive.
It's insane.
Man.
Of course, we're open. We're indoors. The building's been here since 1937.
Yep. I just wish we were getting in early enough to see the show on Friday, because I don't get in until midnight.
Oh, wow. What a shame, man.
I know you have some friends up here, Shane. I know you are.
Oh, yeah. We're all friends with Corey and the Kickin' Excess guys.
Yeah, they've played here several times.
We'd like to thank her for getting us in here to the show.
Kathy's the best. We love her here. She's part of our family here at the Landis.
Yep, I have to give out a shout out, I guess, to another Dallas band, but the guy is from New Jersey. It's called High Infidelity. They're an REO Speedwagon tribute. I've been relying on them and some of the other guys I know from growing up in the area to try to spread the word to get some interest in it and ticket sales. But
that's another great band. REO is like one. They got so many hits, man.
Yeah.
They're another one. I talk about what's her name that was here. Sean, she plays for Sean Starship. Chloe. Yeah, she was here, and she's the singer for Starship now. And I remember I went to see, somebody's like, oh, you want to go see Starship? I'm like, who the fuck wants to see Starship, right? I go to see Starship. I knew every single song they played, and I didn't even realize. I'm like, that's a Starship song?
Yeah.
That's a Starship song? Yeah. REO Speedwagon's that way, man. They have some great hits, man. Yeah. It's like, and Dokken's another one. I know it because I know Dokken, but a lot of people don't realize that's a Dokken tune. That's a Dokken tune, you know? Again, Dream Warriors. People don't know that's a Dokken tune, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I know it's a Dokken tune. I bought the Dream Warrior freaking vinyl just because it said had a Dokken sticker on it, and I left the sticker on it. You know what I mean? I'm that anal about it. You know what I mean?
I'm getting a call from Texas. Is that somebody from your end?
I don't know. Maybe.
That is poor timing.
For fun.
That's funny.
That is poor timing.
It could be a hacker, too, or a spam.
Yeah, right?
That gets true, too. There's a lot of those everywhere now. But look, Shane, thank you so much for coming on, man. We really appreciate it. Okay, the show is rocking. Okay, it is a tribute to Dokken. Again, everybody says tribute. I like to call it an experience. Come here, experience Dokken like you remember him back in the day. It's Saturday, March 30th. Show starts at 8. The doors open at 7 at 8 o'clock sharp. Their special guest, which is Rockstar Revolution, is going to take the stage for a little bit, and they're going to blow your mind with some great music as well, and prepare us for the Rockin' a Tribute to Dokken show again this Saturday, March 30th, from Texas.
Yeah, man,
the Lone Star State, baby, mm-hmm. in New Jersey, bringing our boy Shane back to Pennsylvania.
So since we don't have bagels down here, what do we need to bring in? Maybe we'll stop and get moonshine along the way.
I heard there's some damn good steaks that come out of Texas. I'm just saying, man. A cooler, big truck can fit a cooler, right?
Yeah, that or some barbecue sauce.
Yeah. Oh, dude, hey, I will say I went to when I was in the military, I did go to a one of those barbecue cook-off things in Texas. Best one I've ever been to in my life.
I can imagine.
It was, and they're like, they compete.
Was it chili?
They compete.
I heard there's amazing chili cook-offs,
too. I thought you went to a chili one.
I went to a chili one, too. But the chili thing was a big fight there because they don't put beans in their chili.
Yes. That's the way.
Yeah, and I will tell you, beans are great. But when you have Texas chili, just the regular Texas chili without all the beans and all that garbage in it, it is good, man. It is good. It is.
Nothing like a Texas red, dude.
No, man. Texas is. Yeah, you're right, man. I forgot about how good the barbecue sauce and everything is there. And the chili. It's phenomenal. The way chili should be made. I'm sorry.
A lot of places down here make it with brisket, chopped brisket.
We have. You will enjoy it. We have smokers. We have a restaurant next door. It's actually called Casey Ray's, named after my girlfriend and myself. And it's next door. And we actually have smokers there. And we smoke our own brisket. We smoke our pulled pork, too. So, and we do a pretty damn sweet brisket. We do a peach pulled pork, like a peach rub on that. It comes out really nice. So you'll have to try our brisket when you come down. We'll get you a brisket sandwich. You can try it out.
Right. Yeah, sounds good. I'll hit it up.
But you know what? You bring the barbecue sauce. We'll bring the brisket. How's that?
It sounds good.
See that?
And maybe I'll get the guys to stop in Tennessee somewhere and bring some moonshine out.
Tennessee whiskey, baby. Ain't nothing like it. Ain't nothing
Sing
like it.
Sing it, baby.
I remember.
Please don't.
I was shooting for it.
Have any of you guys ever been to the Jack Daniel's distillery in Tennessee?
No, I haven't.
Oh, it's a great, you can't drink there. It's a dry area.
Yep.
But I tell you, it's such a cool, if you get a chance, if you're going through Tennessee, just stop. It is the coolest thing, man. The way they show you the whole process.
Yeah.
But the water. Yeah. Actually comes from a stream, a spring underground, and you can go down.
Mm-hmm.
When it was like 110 degrees the day we went down there, you get about 40 feet down, and it is freezing cold.
Wow.
The water, you just dip a cup, and it's unbelievable. Mm-hmm. It's really cool, though. It's really cool.
Isn't the whole town like a dry town, though?
Yeah, Lynchburg is completely dry.
But like a mile outside, you can literally buy everything Jack Daniel's sells.
Yes. they know what they can and can't.
Yeah, they're smart there. They're smart there. And it's funny because everything's got like government locks on it and stuff, and they got to unlock it to show you how the charcoal. They make their own charcoal, too.
Wow.
They literally burn wood out back. They have these big fires going, and they spritz it with water while it's burning, and they create their own charcoal. It's all charcoal filtered. Through their own charcoal. It's pretty cool. It's pretty neat. But yeah, Tennessee whiskey. There's nothing like Tennessee whiskey, baby.
Man. Yeah, we're stoked to be coming up. So thanks for having us on and having us here.
Shane, thank you so much, man. We're looking forward to it. Again, I love that hat. You know, you could just bring a hat and I'd be happy, man. That is such a kick-ass hat, brother. That is kick-ass. Shane, thank you so much for coming on, brother.
Yep, thanks for having us.
We can't wait, man. This is going to be a great show. Again, let's go back to the it is Rokken, a tribute to Dokken. It is Saturday, March 30th, 7 o'clock, doors open, and the show starts at 8 promptly with Rockstar Revolution opening up, their special guest. This is going to be a really good show, man. I am really excited because I love, again, I'm one of those freaks that just loved Dokken. Still do. Man. Please,
stir some shit up here, huh?
Yeah, look at him go. Well, dude, put that back on. Is that guitar camouflage?
Yeah, the tiger stripe.
Oh, yeah, that's the tiger. Yeah, that's such a cool guitar, man. Look at the feathers on it.
Feathers,
yeah.
I also
have a nice little Lynch Mob video in case you wanted to.
Plug a little Lynch Mob? Yeah. Let's do it. Throw some Lynch Mob up. Let's get people ready for Dokken, man.
It got me thinking. It was Dokken, you know?
Dude, let's get people ready for the show.
Oh, I hope
show,
it's a Dokken song.
I hope it is, too, because it might be a Lynch Mob song.
I can't play the sound at the same time. I'm like,
just go for it. Just go for it. Into the fire. Yeah, that dude. It. So that was the Lynch Mob playing Into the Fire, one of the great Dokken hits.
What a great show.
Dude, such a good show, man. And that's before the walls became the walls.
Yep.
You know, so and he was mesmerized then. Can you imagine what's going to happen when he comes back? He's going to say, fuck it, man. I'm going to do one more year.
Yeah.
One more year in the row, which should be good for Jaren. So.
I would agree. Yeah. I would agree. That guy deserves it, man.
Hey, real quick, Case, do you have because we opened the show with a little Starman, and I think we owe them a little throw a little bit more Starman in there, because I wanted people to really see what they missed this weekend. Because
absolutely,
when they come back, we're talking about doing Station to Station next.
Oh, nice.
Which is a tough album to do,
hmm,
and a great album. So yeah, go for it, Case. Lynch Mob. No. God, man, that audience had such a good time, man.
The spacesuit was a great addition,
dude,
guys.
What a
great. God, that was a brand new costume for them.
Joe Morrison, we have a spacesuit for you to wear next time they come, and I will buy it.
Can we make him float?
Oh no, it's one of those ones you.
Can you hit up the guys from Spider-Man and get that rig in here?
Oh, dude, I could do a good job. They can with some rope
get that rig. Yeah, true. They didn't exactly do the greatest job.
Give me a pack of gum.
They did not have the best track record. I wouldn't be on that if I was Joe. Just have his ass floating all around. It could be a little slower though, than they were.
But Joe Morrison, man, I have got the spaceman costume for you. It's got a little battery. It goes up your ass. You hit the button. Blows up. It's pretty sweet, man. It's actually pretty
Joe,
sweet.
Just so you know, we saw the space costume and we thought of no one else.
Except Joe. Real quick, Steve, you want to hit this read number four?
Yeah, there we go.
We got a lot of reads here. You know what?
We're missing read number one.
Why don't you hit read number one? You can hit number four before we get off here, because it is 8:52.
So guys, big thank you to our sponsor, Michael Kelly Guitars. Uncle Steve Pisani of Radio Flashback, he is the head honcho over there at Michael Kelly Guitars, and they have been donating guitars for our fundraisers and benefits here at the Landis. Check them out at michaelkellyguitars.com.
I will tell you,
beautiful work.
I have a meeting next week. We are going to announce our new sponsor for the Battle of the Bands this summer.
Kick ass!
And we're going to keep it very local. We're going to stick with like very local bands. I'm even thinking about having a acoustic side and a band side.
Oh, so that's awesome!
Have two different things. And Michael Kelly Guitars is going to donate a guitar and a wireless microphone set up for the winner of the band.
That's nice.
Battle band. So that's really cool, man. They're going to throw a guitar and a microphone up in there for it. So that's really cool.
Tease right there.
Really cool. Really cool.
I'm glad to hear the Battle of the Bands.
I don't want to stop that. I think that was so much fun. We just, you know, mm-hmm, what? It was our first year. We got to work the bugs out.
Yeah,
you know?
Absolutely.
Yep. Go ahead, Steve.
Yes.
All on you, brother.
Upstairs at Casey Ray's tonight, we had Jimmy Graham's Comedy Roost open mic. It is always funny trying to advertise this, because they are basically going by the time we even get going. It is, your sign up start at 6 p.m. The show starts at 7. Jimmy is a fantastic guy, for those that don't know. He will help you work on your set. You can come out. You can do your set. You can build your set. You can tell a joke, whatever it is. You know, come on out. Wednesday, Open Mic Dynamite, hosted by Dee Dee Star and Donnie Rocket, from 8 to 11 p.m. There is a $5 cover.
Now,
come on out to that.
Now, listen, the $5 cover is only for people not playing.
Yes. Yes. Performers are free.
Yeah. So if you're performing, you don't have to pay.
Awesome.
If you're coming to watch, hey, man, you're throwing $5 in the hat, you know, to pay for, you know, the guys, mm-hmm, that are putting it on and stuff and bringing these guys out.
So again, really, we have cool, a sound guy. We've got a full lighting setup, full backline, a backing band if you're just a singer or something like that.
Yeah.
If you have a band and you want to bring your whole band, you guys can come. Plug your instruments in and play. You really don't have to bring anything. Guitar amps, bass amps.
It doesn't matter. You can be a rapper. You can be a rocker. You can be a country person. You can be a harmonica playing guy who's amazing.
He's one of my favorites.
Dude comes here with like 700 harmonicas and just blows us away. Killer. Dude, he's so good.
CT, you got to hear him play.
This guy is
like John Popper style.
Dude, he's got he opens up a briefcase of harmonicas, and he's got every key.
And he just goes. He like disappears.
He's so good, man. So good. So
he
good.
He just goes. Thursday.
Pay $5 for him.
Night, Thursday night. What happened here?
Karaoke.
Well,
Joe Morrison made a comment.
Oh God.
What happened? What's the matter?
Oh, no.
Oh, Jesus, God. Dude, squirrels.
Yeah. Let's finish it. Jesus, H. Thursday night karaoke with DJ Paul from 7:30 to 11:30 p.m. A free admission.
I hate that you, is Joe.
Upstairs. Oldies night with DJ Jerry J and DJ John from 5 p.m. to 8
That's
p.m.
That's downstairs.
Free admission. Once again, that is downstairs. On Friday, we have our Fireball Fridays.
But this week, is it not?
It is the music.
The music is here. Oh, yes, they're so good, man. John fantastic. And the boys.
Shout out to John and everyone. They are a great time. Oh, they are so $10, good. I believe, at the door. $10.
Yes. They are $10 at the door.
$10 right, cool. at the door. I believe that is from 8 to 12, I want to say. Yes, 8 to 12. Eight I see Tiff shaking her head over there, and she is nodding in agreement.
Tiffany is our bar manager upstairs. She will be serving and slopping the drinks around. And
slopping them.
And then next week will be Tiff's birthday celebration.
Yes. Whoa. Next week is Tiff's back to the 90s celebration.
Oh, yeah. That's going to be a lot of fun. That's going to be a lot of fun.
She wants to come out and hang with all you guys that she
so she will not be slinging drinks. She'll be sucking down the drinks.
Slurping drinks instead.
Slurping.
So buy them for her.
Yes. Yes.
Yes, but usually Fireball Fridays, $4 Fireball shots from 8 to 10:30 p.m., Fireball giveaways, and it's usually a $10 entry fee. Like we said, for this week, it is the music going on there. An old-school R&B band, and man, they absolutely kill it.
So good,
if it
man.
Is something you're even remotely interested in, if it's something that you think is not for you, I guarantee you, you can come on out and have a fantastic time. They are entertainers, and they know how to do it right. Saturday night, Latin night with a DJ Real Deal from 9 p.m. to 2 a.m. And once again, that is a $10 cover now on Saturdays.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Oh, man. Absolutely. There he is. Dude, Javier is one of our dear friends, man. He's become a part of our family here at this. And what a wonderful guy and such a good DJ, man. And again, hey, man, you know, our good friend Isaiah Pacheco is back in town. He was here this past weekend. I'm sure he'll stop in. We're looking forward to his party on 420.
420
of all the we're gonna have the Pacheco party on 420. We're actually thinking of doing a 420 brunch downstairs. We're talking about it during the day, maybe that's doing cool. A little like brunch. Not you can't get the marijuana and stuff
right
here,
right.
But you can
it
is legal in the state of New Jersey, mm-hmm. So you can go and take all the marrow you want prior to getting here, and you can come here and eat.
Oh, man.
So I recommend edibles.
Yeah. And it will also be the Miss Tri-City Pageant.
Oh, my God. That's going on the same day?
Yes.
What?
6 p.m.
Wow. Oh, man. That is so awesome, man. What a great event we have here. I absolutely love it, man. I think Miss Tri-City is such a great thing, and they do such a great job. It's such a wonderful event. And the girls, you know, they really do, man. It's a way for them to.
We got
to
figure out the rehearsal, though.
What do you mean?
Because it's on a Tuesday night. And I got to do this.
Well, they
and
just
also
have to do
them.
Well, they have to do it after 9 o'clock.
They do it after 9 o'clock.
Life's a bitch, and then they're born.
What? Yes.
Casey's gonna get that one figured out.
Why can't we do it Wednesday?
I would love to.
Well, yeah.
Tell her we're doing it Wednesday. Mm-hmm. Bless her heart. We love you. See you Wednesday for that.
Yes.
Again, Michael Kelly guitars. I just want to thank Uncle Steve again, dude. These are some wonderful instruments behind us. MichaelKellyGuitars.com. I mean, look at these amazing instruments. She turned it off. She stuck that amazing instrument on. But look at these beautiful guitars, man. If anyone knows what this reminds you of, that's exactly what it's modeled off of. This is their custom. It's gorgeous. I mean, if you could see it up close, man, you'd be blown away by this guitar.
It's got a way deeper cut than usual.
Yes,
exactly.
Way
deeper cut.
So
and these
more relaxing.
Actually push and pull, so you can split these things. There's like so seven cool. different combinations. You
no,
can
we
make,
gotta
man.
Do. We gotta tune it up. We gotta
plug
it in. We gotta plug it
in
and play around with it. Yeah, because and I'll take that little girl.
Why does
there.
Back to the Future come to mind with the big giant speaker? Just
that would be amazing. That would be amazing. Yes. Just that one note. MichaelKellyGuitars.com. Again, thank you, Uncle Steve. We love you so much. You were the head honcho over there. Mm-hmm. For myself, again, CT, thank you for joining us again today.
Yeah, I'm
so
happy
good
to be
to
back.
Welcome
man.
Back, buddy.
So
welcome
back.
Back,
man.
So good to see you, man. We missed you, man. And your fucking crazy shirts and hats. And
you bring some
God
color
knows,
to the room here.
God knows what he wears for underwear. Because
true,
it's got to be some of the craziest shit you've ever seen in your life, man. Probably the elephant one with the ears.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
We know exactly what I'm talking about.
One of those Borat V's.
Yes. Oh,
man. Very nice.
I've been wanting one of those. No, I haven't, Casey. No.
I was literally just scrolling on my phone for the elephant pants.
Oh, those are amazing. Like, my God. Don't worry. Don't worry. Anybody who got a Fredericks of Hollywood catalog back in the day, which we all love to get.
Oh, yeah.
Always had the elephant undies in there for the guys. In mm-hmm. the back. You know, they always had like maybe two pages of shit for guys and nothing but naked girls. And they thought it was a catalog. And you're like, oh, this is a great catalog for a 12-year-old boy.
Here's a little more info than you need, but Shinesty is an incredible underwear company. We're not affiliated. Holder? Yeah, dude. In the summertime, it's perfect. Like if you're out all day.
I got the Duluth trading version of that on.
It's all
have the Long great. Islanders gotten my shit's to you, got shade Shinestein? In it.
No, that's what you do. Yeah, you drop your balls in a sack.
It's called
in
a ball underwear. Hammock.
Yeah, and it keeps it. We get it's look,
perfect.
Men are famous for bat wings.
I've heard of a banana
sticks,
hammock.
Ba-boom. No.
It's like you
know how you get like on a hot summer day, you get like.
These ones are called the bullpens from Duluth Trading, and they were about $40 a piece.
I'm a powder man. I use a lot of powder in the summer.
You don't even need them. Precious metal and gemstones in your underwear.
I just told Tiff in my corner what bat wings are.
Oh, yeah. Good job.
Yeah. Good job. Dude, it's a man thing.
Now tell her what a goat is.
And let me tell you, the older you get, the more they wing.
That's exactly right.
I don't want to.
Google it. That's exactly right.
All right, guys. Thank you again, everyone who tuned in and everyone who tunes in this week and watches this, because a lot of people actually watch it after. We'd love to have you on live because I want to at some point be able to get some peeps on and, you know, talk about stuff. I think it'd be kind of cool to get some live people on so we can poke them with sticks and shit. All right.
Sticks came once and now you want to poke.
Oh, thank we got you. Everybody.
Yeah. And you know what? One more time before we say go. Thank you so much to George and all the crew and everyone from Sticks. It was a pleasure having you here at the Landis. Again, thank you so much for this guitar. We're going to put that up in the Blue Room along with some cool signed
awesome.
Albums that you know they signed. Thank you guys for coming and gracing our stage and just being the amazing – dude, go see this fucking mm-hmm. band. You know every song they've ever done. They made some of the most famous songs in the world, and they sound – exactly like they did when I saw them for the first time in the 80s.
Yes.
I'm telling you, Tommy Shaw sounds exactly the same. We were talking backstage before he left, and I looked at him. I said, dude, the only person that's ever come in here that was like you was Glenn Hughes. Glenn Hughes came in same, right around the same age. I think Glenn's a little bit older, mm-hmm. but dude, still sounded like Glenn Hughes back in the 70s. Tommy Shaw still has it. He plays a million guitars and he can sing. I'm telling you, dude, we were just talking about how you don't want to see Dokken. Yeah. I personally breaks my heart to see Foreigner, you know, when
no original.
That's what I'm
members.
Saying. You're not seeing the band, but you're seeing Sticks, man.
Yeah.
And one of the great, to me right now, the best drummer alive on the planet right now plays for Sticks. Mm-hmm. And until Neil Peart passed away,
I got to drive him around.
Yep.
Oh, it's fucking cool.
And if you love
Joe, got to sit behind his set. Which if you love totally rock against, and roll, by the way, I found out afterwards. Like they would have killed them if they found out about that.
Yeah, yeah.
How can you beat Renegade? How can you beat Renegade?
Like, I sat right there and listened to it.
I sat right here and watched the whole dude. When I tell you how great they were, dude, I cannot wait to go see them. We're definitely going to go. They're coming to Camden. And we're going to go see them when they come to Camden.
I will say, you know, they tell you never meet your heroes. These are guys that I would meet time and time again.
That's awesome.
Couldn't have been nicer. They couldn't have been better at what they do. It was a real treat. Real treat.
And Tommy had the grilled cheese and a tomato soup from Casey Ray's and said how wonderful it was. Mm-hmm. So there you go. All right, everyone. Thank you again for joining us here live at the Landis Podcast every Tuesday starting at 7 to 9 with the wonderful Casey behind the scenes there producing
on the
my dear friend Steve and CT back in the house. There she is. Hey, pup. And tonight we actually had a special guest who refuses to put her face on camera, even though she's
there.
There she is. The beautiful Tiffany. She is our bar manager upstairs and we love her. She's a big part of our family here at the Landis. Again, thank you all for tuning in. Thank you, Michael Kelly Guitars. Good night, guys. Have a good one.
Can you dig it?
Yeah.